It's very difficult to articulate the thanks which are needed to be expressed for each and every speaker this evening. All shluchim from the Rebbe Melech HaMashiach, each one has an intensive schedule to keep, and therefore it's with great mesiras nefesh that each and every one of them has got to tear themselves away from their communities and from their schedules in order to honor us with their presence here this evening. So without further ado, I would like to call upon Rabbi Shlomo Zalman Lando, Rosh Yeshiva, Mashpia, from Teimcha Tamimim, in Ranana, in Bnei Brak, and everywhere else in the world, including London, Rabbi Lando.
אומרים תמיד אשרינו מתאים חלקנו, מנועים גורלנו, מיופו יורשותנו. שאין שחסידו זה עניין שנוסה לא נותר הסמץ. הפעם, כמו שהיינו אצל הרב, הפעם הוא לא מרוצה, תמיד צריך יותר מיילים בקודש. אם אפשר, כפליים לתושייה. אז אין מצב שאדם עשה משהו ויגיד, עשיתי. אם עשית, תמשיך הלאה. אם הקדוש ברוך הוא עזר עד פה, יעזור הלאה. רב חסיד, ראובן דונין, תמיד היה אומר משל מהאופניים, שאדם נוסע על אופניים, אם הוא עושה פידלים, הוא בעלייה. אם הוא לא עושה פידלים, אז הוא כנראה בירידה. ולכן, לאילון ועד, אסור להיות, הרב היה מאוד כותב חריף, שאהוב את הביקורת, לא רק לקבל את הביקורת, לאהוב את זה, שזה יעמיד אותך על הגובה האמיתי. ואילו כל שבח וכל עניין כזה מביא חולשה וזה יהיה מאוס אצלך, לא צריך לחפש את השבחים. נפש הבא מספר נשבר, צריך קצת עידוד. מילא, נו, עוד יותר זה וימוי. אבל בענייננו אנחנו צריכים לראות מה יכולים להוסיף בקודש. רב חיים יצחק דיבר קודם, נזכרתי פעם ראשונה שהגעתי פה לבית משיח, לא זוכר כמה זמן זה היה, 10 שנים, מה הזמן הולך מהר היום, לימוי של משיח כבר, אין זמן לספור את הזמן, כי כל יום עובר עניינים שהם מעל הזמן. אבל כל פנים היה איגרס קיידש שהרב אומר לי, נתוועד, נתוועד, ואני לא ידעתי מה הרב מתכוון, שמעתי שיש בבית משיח, לא יודע איפה, באתי לפה, מצאתי את המקום איכשהו, וממש כמו שאומרים, ספרים, וכל העניינים הטובים, הכל נמצא, הכל חי וקיים. פתחתי ספר, מה עוד בקשה עושה? נו, מה עוד אתה רוצה? הביאו אותך פה בלונדון, וכל העניינים הטובים, מה עוד אתה צריך? טוב, אז אם כן, אנחנו מנסים, ובאמת זה ככה מרגישים בבית. העניין של יד הרב, כל אחד מרגיש בבית, כי הרב זה עניין אלוקי, עניין של לעשות טוב לכל יהודי, הטוב האמיתי שהוא צריך, אפילו מה שהוא לא יודע מה טוב בשבילו. אבל כל פנים שעושים מה שהרב אומר, תמיד זה הכי טוב. הרבה פעמים יש ניסיונות לעשות דברים מעל השכל, וצריכים לראות, לא להתווכח עם השכל, להשאיר אותו בצד, ללכת מעל השכל. הרב אומר שבנותו ואביו, שטוי יין נכנסו למקדום. יין זה טעם ודעת. טעם ודעת בחוץ. טעם ודעת צריך להשתמש, אבל בנוסחו אל תשואל, לא להישען על זה, להשתמש בזה. כשרב אומר, עושים מה שאומר בלי שאלות. כי זה שכינה מדברת. ושכינה הרי עם הקדוש ברוך הוא לא מתווכחים. ידוע הסיפור עם אלתר רבה, הגיעו חסידים, נגיד רק לחיים, לחיים, לחיים. הגיעו חסידים לאלתר רבה, והצטננו כולם. הרבה מהם, זאת אומרת. אמרו לאלתר רבה, בליל שמחה סתיר, בליל שמיני עצרת, שהרבה האנשים פה הצטננו. אמר אלתר רבה שיביאו את כולם לבית הכנסת. מעבר לזה גם עשה קידוש. ואמר לשלושה חסידים, כהן, לוי וישראל, שיכוונו לכוונה שהוא מכוון ויחלקו מהיין הזה לכולם, וככה התנהגו. ושם כתוב שהחסידים הכריזו שצריך להאמין בברכה, ואז הברכה תחול באופן אחר לגמרי. ידעו את החסידים לכלל ברזל, עניין של אמונה, טהורה, טהורה בירושה נקייה משכל אנושי. עושים מה שהרב אומר בלי חוכמות. אם כל אחד מבין שרב זה עניין של אין ארוך, אז מה השכל שלך מבין בעניין הזה? תגיד תודה שתנו לך לעשות מה שהוא אומר, להבין. אילו ידעתי ואיסי, והיית בעצמך הרב. על כן, לא שם אותך בתפקיד של רבי, אתה צריך לדעת, לעשות בקבול לסוד. אגב, שם הסיפור שהלכו חסידים להביא את כולם מהבתים, הגיעו לאיזה בית, הבית היה יהודי שלא היה חסיד, יודע הרבה תורה ודיבר עם האלתר רבי בתורה, ומאוד התרשם מהגדלות של האלתר רבי בלימוד, ואמר להם שפשוט אסור להוציא את הזקן הזה מהבית, פשוט עוברים על עשרת דיברס, הוא בסכנה גדולה, תוציאו אותו החוצה לעקור, אז זה ממש הפך התיר. אבל הצעירים לא ידעו חוכמות, הרב אמר להביא את כולם בית הכנסת, והרב יודע את הכל. אז הם מילא צריכים להביא אותו. ואז החסיד הזקן הזה, רב פינחס, שכבר כותב את המאמרים של האלתר רבי, מתחיל לחשוב, מה קורה איתי? אני כותב את המאמרים, כזה מקושר הרבה שנים, איפה האמונה שלי ברב, כמו של הצעירים האלו? הוא מתחיל לחשוב שהוא צריך ללכת ליחידס, הוא צריך לבקש מהרב תיקון. והצעירים אלו, מה אתה חושב גם באוסטרחציה זה יפי? צריכים ללכת לעקופס. עכשיו זה זמן חשבון הנפש, ואני צריך תיקון, ואני צריך יחידס, ואני צריך, ואני, ואני, ואני. מדף תום עוד הרבה בין, מי מעניין אותך מה אתה צריך עכשיו? בקיצר, לקחות גם את הזקן הזה, ולמחרת כולם נהיו בריאים. זה גרם לאותו למדן, כאילו, שנהיה חסיד גם כן. קודם היה למדן, הוא יודע התורה. הוא גם יכול להבין מה אלתר רבי מסביר. כאן הוא הבין שאלתר רבי זה למעלה מטעם הדת. זה למעלה מהטבע. אז זה כל העניין של הרבי, למעלה מהטבע. יצא לי להיות איזו התוועדות בווילנסבורג. בקיצור, בסוף אחד שואל אותי, מה זה השביל הולכים, והרבי עובר בשביל, ויחיד עלינו. אז באמס לא היה לי אותיות להסביר לו אותו רגע. יש עניינים, אפשר להגיד, אבל זה כמו שהוא לא מלובש בעניינים שאנחנו מבינים בשכל. ואחרי זה מוצאי שבת, שנסע לי חזרה, אז בונדתי, מה צריך להגיד לה, מה צריך להגיד לו, להגיד לו. חשבתי להסביר לו שהרבי כל כולו מעל הטבע מההתחלה. כל עניינם, שליחס. תלך למקום רחוק, סוף העולם, נושא חסיד בגשמס, נושא כאילו לבד, וייצור הכל מחדש. מה יהיה עם חינוך, מה יהיה עם כשרות, מה יהיה עם כל העניינים. ולפועל זה עובד. אני חוזר עוד פעם על זה, שהרבי כותב על עצמו שמטבעי אין לי תענוג בעסקנות. ובוודאי שאני לא יכול לתת תענוג למישהו אחר בהסקנות. ככה מכתב של הרבי מתוף שינטס. זה שעניין של הרבי זה קבול לעשות עם עצמו, מסירס נפש לצאת מהרגילות שלו, אם מותר לי להגדיר מילים מגושמות כאלה. אבל כל פנים, מה הקדוש ברוך הוא רוצה? עכשיו צריכים לפעול עם כלל ישראל, אז יוצאים מהחשבונות וזה מה שצריך לעשות. ואשר היהודי עושה בגלל מה שהקדוש ברוך הוא שכינו מדברס, כשהולכים בשליחות הזאת, לא רק החסידים מצליחים, גם אלו שלא קוראים לעצמם חסידים, ערכים ועוד כל מיני, כבר אומרים שיש להם סניפים בכל העולם. יצא לי להיות בלוס אנג'לס, היה ערב, שהם עשו שם מישהו, כמה שלוחי פרוטסטנט הובילו אותי שאני צריך ללכת לשם. טוב, אבל מעניין לשמוע, יש לנו סניפים בכל העולם, אז רציתי להגיד, אז תכריזו יחין, רבנו שלנו. אם הרבי כבר פעל עליכם שאתם נקראים בדרך הטבע מסנגנים, ופועלים באותו דבר שהרבי פועל. ובהתחלה התנגדתם וכל מיני, בסוף אתם עושים בשמחה ומתו לבר, יש לו סניפים בכל העולם, ניזוק שני, חיל, פשטייני, שיבוס, מה אתה? לא בסדר, לא נכריח אותך. הקופונים לענינו, הנקודה הוא שיש כאן עניין אלוקי. ואתכם לא צריך להיות בטלן, לצאת ביטול, ולהתבונן מה שקורה. יהודי אחד הגיע להתוועדות של הרבי מאוחר, כי התפלל בעריכות. אז הרב אמר לנו, התבוננת בגדולת השם, מה אם יסבול לנו? זו הגדולה של הרב הריאה. אז צריך ללמוד את המאמרים של הרב הריאה, את השיחות, שיחות רשימת המאסר. אחד אמר, איזה ליטאי, אחד אומר, מה, לא מדסי שיותר בליקוטי שיחס, אז מה הרב חסיד גדול של הרב הריאה כל כך? וקראתי רשימת המאסר, הבנתי. אתה יכול לתת את החיים שלך, לעמוד מול הרובה ולהישאר אדיש, בסדר, אז יעבירו אותי מעולם הזה, לעולם הבא, מה קרה? אצלנו, השם ישמור, עשו את זה בלשון הרע לעצמו, איך זה קורה? הרבי באדישות תולה לא מעניין אותו שום דבר, רק הקדוש ברוך הוא. אומר הרבי, זה שברת הקליפה של רוסיה. מה זה רוסיה? אנחנו, וחס ושלום, הקדוש ברוך הוא לא מזכירים אותו. מה מפריע לך שיהודי שומר תורה מצוות? לא, רוסיה, אין הדבר אחר חוץ מרוסיה. זה האבא, זה האמא, וחוץ מזה אין כלום. אז אשבור את הקליפה הזאת שכך עם היצמיוני, אלוקות, הקדוש ברוך הוא, וטרו, ומצווס, וזהו, והם נכנעו בסוף. הרב שיצא מרוסיה, כמו שאמר יהודי, חיי אדם לא תפסו מקום אצלהם, זה היה סכנת התאבדות, לא מסירות נפש, ואחר כך הקדוש ברוך הוא יעשה ניסים, אלא לכתחילה אין סיכויים לצאת בחיים. אז זה עניין של למעלה מכל חשבון. הרב שמוסעיד אמר, שהוא עם הבולשוויקים לא יכול להיות באותו עולם. ולכן הרב הרי אמר שהאיסטנטוס של הרב הרי שם היה לפני הזמן, בגיל 59. כי לא היה נראה שהולך להיות איסטנטוס, שהרב הרי שם אמר, אני הולך לשמיים, אני משאיר לכם את הכתבים, הרב הרי ציוון, כאילו, טטטטטה, הרב הרי שם אמר לו, איספיילס, מויכן מויכן. ואמרו שזה המשיך על הרב הקודם, מוכין חדשים, כוחות של רב, שצריך לא להתמודד עם חושך ממש, להיכנס לכלא בסכנת חיים, ולשבור את הקליפה הזאת. אז זה רק הכוח הזה שבלי חשבון עצמוס ממש, לשבור קליפה כזאת כמו רוסיה. לכן כשהרב יוצא מהשר, ג' תעמוס, תוף ריש בזיין, הרב אומר שיחה בתחנת הרכבת. הרבה חסידים באו לשמוע, זה היה מסירות נפש לבוא. אבל הרב אומר שהרבה חסידים חשבו שהולך להיות יותר גרוע. היה לחץ עולמי, והרוסים מפחדים מה העולם יגיד, שחררו את הרב. עכשיו שולחים אותו לקסטרמה, הלחץ העולמי, העולמי ירד, והשם ישמור, מי יודע מה הם יעשו כשאין לחץ עולמי. מה האמת? שאחרי 9 ימים הוא השתחרר לגמרי. אז מה הרב היה צריך להגיד בתחנת הרכבת? חבר'ה, הכל עוד 9 ימים עומד להיות גאול לאמיתיס ושלמו. אל תשלח מחשוב אזור איזה שהולך להיות יותר גרוע. למה הרב לא אומר כלום? אז הגיעו חבר'ה למסקנה שפשוט, אם אתה לא מבין שהרב לחם עם קליפה, ואם הוא ניצח אותה, אז רק יהיה יותר טוב, אין מקום ליותר חס שלום אחרת. למה יש לך בכלל מחשבות שהולך להיות אחרת? אז פשוט אותו מסנגל שמחפש גם במגיל הססטרי, זה פסוק בניגל של איכו, יותר מדי שמח פה, זה משהו מעניין, איזה אקשן משהו. אז חייב לחפש, זה משהו, מה, לא, 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 גאולה אמיתית ושלמה, נו, אנחנו בגלות הרבה זמן, תן לנו עוד קצת גלות, מה? סיפורים שתי זקנים היו בכלא, סיפרו סיפורים אחד לשני. הודיעו לאחד הזקנים, אתה משוחרר. רגע, אני באמצע סיפור, שנייה. על דרך הסיפור הידוע, שיהודי אחד בהרצליה, נהיה גביר, הוא זכה בפיס, אז הוא בא לרב הלפרין, שיהיה בריא, והוא אומר לו שאני עכשיו זכיתי את ישיר ואני אתרום וזה, אבל אני מבקש שבערב פסח, שאני עומד לקבל את המצות ואת כל צורכי הסדר, שאני לא אצטרך לעמוד בתור, שאני אקבל ראשון. הוא פשוט לא קלט שנהיה גביר, והוא יותר לא צריך לבקש. הציון לדעת שמאז הבעל שם טוב, אנחנו נמצאים בגאולה. יתגלה אור אלוקים מאין לעתיד לבוא, שאין עת מלבדו. זה מה שיתגלה לא עושה לא מבניג לכבד הווי, זה תאמר ויותר מתאימה יתגלה בזמן הבעל שם טוב, ואל תראה בה, המגיד, כן? ואחר כך אל תראה בה, הרידו למטה באורץ, שכל אחד יוכל להבין בשכל אנושי שאין עת מלבדו. אני זוכר פעם ראשונה שמעתי, הסבתי שדיבר אקסידס, הרגשתי פשוט חירות בנפש. כי עד היום, מה אני צריך, מה אבא שלי יגיד, ומה החברים יגידו? אתה פשוט לא מרגיש, עובד את השם. סידו, האם יש יותר, ואפשר להבין שיש קדוש ברוך הוא. אז אחד כותב לרבא, שאולי הרבא פעם אחת יוכיח לו שיש קדוש ברוך הוא, ושיותר לא יהיה לו ספקות. אז הרבא שואל אותו אם הוא נגע פעם בחוט חשמל. אז הוא אומר שכן, נו, קיבלת זרם. אוקיי, ראית מישהו? אז למה אתה לא נוגע עוד פעם בחוט הזה? הרי לא ראית אף אחד. פעם אחת נגעת בחוט חשמל וקיבלת זרם, הגוף שלך קלט, יש משהו שלא רואים אותו, ותיזהר ממנו, הוא מרביץ. אז זה לא כדאי עוד פעם לקבל מכה כזה. אז אם כי אומר, אתה חי בעצמך עם דבר שאתה לא רואה, ואתה בטוח שהוא נמצא. אני, סליחה על העני הזה, אבל זה האמת. היינו במגדל העמק בשליחס, לא היה לנו משפיע, אין עצם לבד. בזכות זה למדנו הרבה חסידס, כי אף אחד לא התחיל להסביר לנו בשיעורים, שום דבר צריך פשוט ללמוד כל הספר הלאה והלאה. אז גמרנו רנת ואתר והשאלות, רשמנו בצד. ענייננו, היה לנו זכות להכיר את רב ראובן דונין. זה היה מי שהיה יכול להתוועד. וראו יהודי מלא חיות פנימית והתקשרות אמיתית לרבי. פושט היה לו קירובים גדולים מאוד, הוא היה אדם אמיתי, הרבי כנראה לפי מה שאהב את האמת שלו. והרב נתן לו רשות להיכנס ליחידס מתי שהוא רוצה, פילפלו. היה לו קירובים מאוד גדולים. אני מתחיל עם נקודה קצת, הרב אמר לו שהוא לא יעשה סיגופים, הוא רוצה לתקן את העבר שלו, לא לא לא, שיוכל וישן והכל. יום אחד הרב פוגש אותו, אחרי יחיד איזה, שתיים בלילה, מה? רובנר, הרב אומר תוך אוגרת, את הפושט עשם לשלוף, סיכמנו, שצריך לאכול ולישון, אז מה אתה עיר עכשיו? מי שיקר את רובנר, האיש אמת, אז גם מול הרב הוא אמיתי, והוא אומר לרב, ולמה הרב עיר עכשיו? נאור חוצפן, מה? אז מה הרב צריך לענות לו? אז הרב עונה לו, איזלר ופומיר נאור דיגות עזף. תלמד ממני רק את הדברים הטובים. זה גאונות אלוקות בעדינות פנימית נפשית אלוקית פשוט. זה לא הרב חשב מה להגיד, זה הרב. אלוקות וגמר, מסתכל על כל יהודי, או יש לו יהודי, נפש ואמיץ צריכים, מה אפשר לעזור לו? לא, הוא טוב, הוא לא טוב, מה אפשר לעזור ליהודי הזה? איך אפשר לעזור לנשמה שתעשה את התפקיד שלה? חסרונות, מה זה נוגע? בקיצר, רובן הגיע ליחידס לרבן. רבי שלמה חי אמר לו שהדבר הראשון שהרבן אומר לו ביחידס, זה נוגע לכל החיים. מה הרבן אומר לו בדבר ראשון? הרבן שואל אותו אם הוא מבין רק בציוד כבד או גם בציוד קל. האם הוא מבין רק בטרקטורים או גם במכוניות? כי הוא עבד בטרקטורים קודם. רב רובן התחיל לבכות פשוט בדמעות של איש, הוא יזדעזע, מה זה מה שנוגע לי לכל החיים? הטרקטור הזה שאני רוצה לצאת ממנו ולתקן את הדבורים בטיילים שהיה פה. עכשיו עוד פעם, ביחיד הזה צריך לשמוע הטרקטור על מכוניות. אז הרב שאל אותו למה אתה בוכה? הוא לא יכל לענות. אז הרב שאל אותו, בשביל מה ביקשת להיכנס ליחיד? יחיד את פירושו שהרב יודע מי הנשמה שלך, גם מה עשה בגלגול קודם, ויודע בדיוק מה התיקון שלך, מה אתה צריך לעשות. אז אם אתה רוצה להציע לרבא מה הוא צריך להגיד לך, אז אל תיכנס ליחידס, אז תעשה לבד מה שאתה יודע. אז הוא אומר לרבא, אני באתי פה להיות בקדושה, כאילו בישיבה. טוב, אז הוא אומר, אוקיי, אם ככה נדבר עוד כמה חודשים. אחרי כמה חודשים הרבא אמר לו שהוא צריך לנסוע לחיפה ולעבוד על הטרקטור. זה כמו רבי סבא לגול. מה הטרקטור הזה? רוצים לעזור בתשובה? רוצים? טוב. בקיצר, ברוך השם, שיש קבלת טוב ועושים מה שהרב אומר, הרי מכל התורה זה נייס, זה קדם לנשמה, חיים. ומילא, בחיפה האדומה, הדתיים הפרזיטים, לא רוצים לעבוד, חיים מהחשבון אחרים, פה בא יהודי עם זקן גדול, ועובד על הדבר הכי מגושם, טרקטור. זה פשוט עשה מהפכה בחיפה. והאוטובוס עצר לו לפני התחנה, כדי שיוכל לרדת איפה שצריך לעבוד, וכל האוטובוס מדבר. שלמה עוצרים פה, זה לא התחנה, כי הדתי הזה הולך לעבוד על הטרקטור. אחר כך הוא חוזר מהעבודה, אנשים חיכו לו בבית לשיעור בטניה, והם אומרים, זוכים את הריח של הזיעה מהבגדים של העבודה, וככה הוא למד את הטניה, מה יעשה, הם חכים. קיצר בסוף אנשים אמרו לו, אתה יודע למה חזרנו בתשובה? כי באת לבית שלנו עם הטרקטור. אז הוא אומר, הרב אומר לי ביחידות, אם אני מבין בציוד כבד או גם או בציוד קל, ואני עונה לו שאני רוצה להיות בקדושה. נו, נו, הטרקטור הזה, הוא גוף, הוא מיני ובי, עצמוס איסוף, יש אני בו, הוא יש האמיתי, הטרקטור הזה יעשה בעלי תשובה, זה התיקון. אבל זה לא עלה על דעתו. סברים, אני אסיים רק, יש פה, היה פעם אנשים שהיו צריכים להיכנס ליחידס, בגדר החיצוניות לא עדיין חבלניק עם כל עניין לא משנה, אבל קיצרים צריכים להיות באותו לילה בית רפואה עם הבן שלהם, לקבל אנטיביוטיקה, אבל ליחידס אז ויתרו על הבית רפואה. ליחידס לקח מאוד מאוחר, היה ארבע בבוקר, בסוף אמרו לרבא היינו צריכים ללכת בית רפואה, וויתרנו, אז מה לעשות? הוא אומר, לא, לא צריך אנטיביוטיקה, תן דבש. אז הוא נורא, אז ניסינו כבר כמה פעמים לפני שבאנו לפה. אז הוא אומר, זה לפני שבאתם לפה, אחרי שבאתם לפה, אז יהיה באופן אחר. אחרי שהרבא אומר תן דבש, אז כבר זה יעבוד. כן, כשהרב אומר משיח, הרב יש תמונה שהרב מרים את שתי הידיים, טוב שממחס, באמצע קשר ברוך הוא, שם את הגביה, וממש בשטורם הכי גודל. אני אמרתי משהו, אתה יודע, תנועה כזאת לא היה 40 שנה. אין דבר כזה שהרב יוריד את הגביה, תמיד את הגביה עם יד אחד ככה. כשהרב יוריד את הגביה ועם שתי הידיים, זז משהו בשמיים, זה תפנת תשמח, זז משהו בשמיים, זה הגיע גילוי חדש, שהרב מרים את הגביה ושתי הידיים. אותו דבר, כל הימים של הרבא, זה הרבא הקודם אמר על הרבא, שכתב את היום יום, שיקח את המסגרת של הרבא עכשיו. ותעתי גוון הפנימי, הוא דוביס הפנימי. כן, הרבא לא אמר ולא עשה דבר, שהוא לא ידע שהוא 100% שם. וכל מה שהוא הגיש שלא צריך לפרסם משיח, אז לא. ושהגיע הזמן שכן, למה? כי הקדוש ברוך הוא פרסם את הרבה. בטוב שנון א' צפצפו טילים בבני ברק, וכולם יודעים מה המסנגד אמר, חמור לצלן שלא נדע, ומה הרבה אמר. אז אם כן, אז הקדוש הוא פרסם את הרבה, הצדיק נסתר של הדור, שהולך עם כובע אפור וחליפה קצרה, כאשר הוא בקיא בכל התורה כולה. לא, הרבה הקודם, אני כלום, יושב ליד הרבה, לא מעיז לדבר מילה, הכל ביטל לגמרי, אין את מלבדוי. ואוהל לך ומי סיב, נשיא לו ראינו את הרבה דשבר, אני רק לוקח את הפתקים לאוהל, אסקר על הציון. לא, לא, אני הרבה הקודם, ברכות שלו, הצלחות שלו. אבל הגיע הזמן, גאולתכם, אז הקדוש הוא פרסם את הרבה ואומר, זהו זה, נגמר עצני עליך. הבעיה רק אחת, שכמה יחידים הבינו את העניין גם לפני זה, שהרבה מלך המשיח, הרבה זה אלוקות, וכל אחד שרצה והתבונן, אז הרגיש, ואם ביקש מהרבה שהרבה יתגלה אליו, אז הרבה יתגלה לאנשים, מי שביקש באמת. על כן, אז מי שהרגיש את העניין, אז הרבה הסכים לקבל ממנו את היחי, את החתימה, את הכל. אז אותו דבר זה ממשיך. העניין הוא הרבה זה אמת. רב ראובן אמר שמי שלא היה מקושר לפני ג' תמוז, מצא אחרי ג' תמוז תירוץ. הסקשנות בראשו, זה לא סטיקר, הסקשנות בראשו שהרבה זה החיים שלך. אף אחד לא יכול להפריע לזה. אם זה חלק מהנשמה שלך, אתה בלי הרבה לא יכול לחיות, אז אין מה שיסתיר על העניין הזה. זה רבה זה עניין אלוקי, למעלה ממקום, למעלה מכל הגבלות. השאלה האם נוצר התקשרות ועל זה צריך להתייגע. קודם שראינו דוגמה כזאת שיהודי, אז כנראה אפשר, וכשיהודי מבקש, הרבה הרשם בכה, למה הקדוש הוא מתגלה רק לאברהם אבינו? אז הרבה אומר, כיוון שהוא בכה, העניין נוגע לו, אז הקדוש הוא מתגלה אליו. אז היה סמרבו והיה עם בי, זה כל הגילויים שידוע מה שהיה, הגילויים ששמעם תורה של הבעל שם, הכל עניינים, אם נוגע לך העניין, ייתנו לך. הכל בין זה הוא כל החסידס, כל החסידס שהעניין יהיה נוגע, ויהיה נוגע באמת, קצת צריך להגיד לחיים שישרוף קצת, אני חושב שבא מיבין שמתכוונים ברצינות, ועבר לזה, שנבקש באמת ההתגלות, זה יגיע. חיים.
Grace Yosher Koyach, Rav Lando, for your inspiring words. Now we move on to the next speaker, somebody who is particularly close with me personally and with Beis Mashiach in London, a shliach of the Rebbe Melech HaMashiach, who words cannot possibly do justice to the enormous work, the enormous positive activities which he does in the field throughout the whole world. Not one country gets left by where Rabbi Gluck is not personally involved day and night in helping Jews and non-Jews. And therefore, without further ado, it's my great honor and privilege that he has managed to tear himself away from other very important engagements this evening to come and honor us with his presence and his divrei chizuk and brocha. Rabbi Gluck.
Chaim Yitzchik. Kohen, doch am Mevorech Am Yisrael ba'ava, that the Kohen, sign of a Kohen is a proper Kohen, is if he has Ava. Like the Gemara says in Yuma, that everyone went, everyone left the Kohen, and he was told that Avde, someone who does the work of a Kohen. Tonight is Yutis Kislev. Not Taki Yutis Kislev, but 3 days before Yutis Kislev, like the Rebbe said on many occasions, that we're already in the Avi of Yutis Kislev, And tonight is Yud Zayin Kislev. Yud Zayin is Bigimatria Toiv. Good. Remember hearing a sikh from the Rebbe, Simchas, Shiva also Betamuz. And the Rebbe koch sich the whole time, and the in Yud Zayin is Bigimatria Toiv. And the Rebbe brought a Gemara, Daf Yud Zayin im Sechte Broches. And the Rebbe said, it's Yud Zayin Omed Aleph. And then you saw the Rebbe going through the Gemara with his, in his thoughts. You saw him going line by line. And then he said, it's a Gemara in the big lines of Daf Yud Zayin Omed Aleph. And then he spoke about Noshe B'mai Zachyin, which is in the big lines on Daf Yud Zayin. If in Tammuz Yud Zayin is a gewaldike tog, Tammuz is shaykh to Esav, Yehofru Yomi Meilu, Allah has come of a Kama Chodesh Kislev, which is a Chodesh al Gula, a Chassidish Chodesh, full mit Yomim Toivim. Zicher Yud Zayin in Yud in Kislev is Goa Gewaldike Tog. And when we think about Toiv, B'chodesh Kislev, is ein Toiv el Teure. And befrat, the Yone Teure, what Niskala B'chodesh Kislev, what Yudas Kislev is Rosh Hashanah L'chassidus. What the Alter Rebbe said that the 53 days, the Gan Yomim, which he was in prison, was connected the Nun Gimel Prokim in Tanya, Yom LePerik. The Rebbe's Doi HaShvi to the Alter Rebbe, and the Rebbe's first Maimer, which gave the leitmotif for his Nesias, what all the Rabbeim is tak is one Bechidah. So the Rebbe said that Mefrekt, why do you ask the Shmaim Meshaych to this Rebbe, to the other Rebbe? Because and the Shailas are Shailin Teure Zeich Teure. That all the Rabbeim are one Mo'oi, the one Metzias. They express themselves in Manig Lefi Hador, that the Manig has to deal, has to be Mashbia to the door which he's in. But the Etzem is also Ein Bechinah. The first mime of the Rebbe is Boser Legani. Legani is Nun Gimel. That what's and the Rebbe's Doi HaShvi to the Alter Rebbe. So his beginner is to take Tanya and to bring the Mayonis of the Alter Rebbe that it should be accessible to every Yid. What's the first Nekuda of Tanya? The Alter Rebbe wrote in the Shablat, the Nekuda of Tanya is Levai Eichu Koroiv Me'oid, Ki Koroiv Eilecho Hadova Me'oid, Beficho Uvilvovcho La Soisoi. That every Yid is Korv to Torah Mitzvahs. Sai in Machshove, Sai in Dibur, Sai in Maise, Levai Eichu Korv Me'oid. What did the Rebbe do? The Rebbe showed every Yid Eichu Korv Me'oid. Bepashtes. The Rebbe opened up Botei Chabad, sent Shluchim to jeder Pinnin Dachas in Welt. Levai Eichu Korv Me'oid, to show that it's Korv Me'oid, that every Yid can be Neskar to Yiddishkeit. The Rebbe made tanks of the mitzvah tanks. What's a mitzvah tank? I remember when the Rebbe first started the Inyan of mitzvah tank in Toshin Lamed Dalet. Now we're coming from 100 years of the First World War, when the whole idea of tank was invented. What was the ufto of a tank? A tank was, in the First World War, no side could win over the other side. They're all stuck. The tank changed the whole atmosphere of war. It showed that you can come to a place where before was impossible to come. You couldn't go there with a horse, you couldn't go there with a car, you couldn't go there with a van. But with a tank, with a special types of how it's made, it can come to a place where others can't come. So the Rebbe showed that you can come to a Yid who's on Fifth Avenue or by Hyde Park Corner, by Champs-Élysées, and show him that Yiddishkeit is here. Just step up and put on tefillin. Step up and then give tzedakah. Step up and learn the Avot Torah. Korev Moed, mitzvah gereres mitzvah. The Rebbe Rashab said that the Inyan of Yutis Kislev is Hazayis Hazek Asher Keshat Kodesh Oisei Hemeitz Shmanu. That Hazayis, an olive, when you grind it up, it gives out its oil. The Alter Rebbe, when he was in prison, when he came out, that was the Ike Hiskalus of Chassidus, was like they say by Chassidim, after Petrburg, after the Alter Rebbe came out of prison. Chodesh Kislev is connected with oil. Nes of Chanukah, which is very close to Yutis Kislev. What's the Inyan of Chanukah? Is Lohores Achutz. To illuminate the darkness. Till the Ragli the Tamador, even the lowest level of those who seem to be rebelling against the Eibishter, against Torah, that we have the capacity, we have the ability to be Mechala Ragli the Tamador, to bring a Kiloyoin, Kalus HaNefesh, to even the lowest levels, even the Ragli the Tamador of those who rebel. The Rebbe said we need to open up our eyes. What shall we need to open up our eyes? There are people who forget the context. When we speak about Mashiach, we have to think in context. Shnei alofim yomois haMashiach. Yomois haMashiach didn't start in Tovshin Yud, it didn't start in Tovshin Yud Aleph. Didn't start in Tovshin Mem, it didn't start in Tovshin Nun. Shnei Alofim Yomois HaMashiach, it started a long, long time ago. And within the past 100 years, Gedoyli Yisroel Mikol HaChugim, Sai Chasidim, and Sai Litvisha, and Sai Lives and Chabadis Ei Misnagdim, all said that today we are in with my grandfather, Oliver Sholem, was a Yekesh Yid, Oberlander Yid. And when there was the first Knesset Gadola of Agudas Yisrael in Vienna, where he lived, the Chofetz Chaim was by the Knesset Gadola. And by the Knesset Gedolah, the Davin Mincha, and my Zayda was the Shlich Tzibbur, was the Chazan. After they finished davening Mincha, the Chofetz Chaim came up to my Zayda and said, Why didn't you say Kabbonis before Mincha? Bible and Eden, they don't say Kabbonis before Mincha. And the Chofetz Chaim was Mamshich. And said, Bald kum Mashiach. Mashiach is coming soon. And when Mashiach comes, that we bring in Kabbonis, we'll bring Kabbonis. But Mela, one should be Makbid to say Kabbonis before Mincha. So the whole concept, it's not like Lahavdil, that there was a time of the Shabbosei Tzvi. So recently I saw Xavis Kashchus to the Shabbosei Tzvi, Mamish Appel, my dirty Yisrael, I'm gechasmet of the Xavis Kashchus. Here Lahavdil is very different. Here, schon already for 100 years, dirty Yisrael, Mikol HaChugim, Sai Ashkenazim, Sai Svadim, Sei Mikolowin von allen chassidischen Kreisen, von allen litwischen Kreisen, von allen olympischen Kreisen, sind als jetzt steht man paar Bias am Mashiach. Wo der Rebbe, and the Rebbe came in that context and said that it's up to us. We have to open up our eyes and we'll see Mashiach. It's waiting for us. All we have to do is put the Aleph. We have to put the Aleph in Geula. Bring the Geula. Through Aleph. Aleph means teach. Teach yourself, teach someone else. Become a little bit better, like Rav Zalman said before, Meilim B'Kodesh. The Emes Havaya La'olam. Like we said in Tehillim before, that the Emes and Metzias of the world is Havaya, is Gedlachkeit. Well, this is the Parshas HaShavua. Parshas HaShavua is, B'Yishlach Yaakov Melochim El Esav. Yaakov said Melochim to Esav. What did he say to Esav? Vihili shoy im loven gati, vihili shoy vachamoy. Vihili shoy vachamoy, speaking to Esav. So what the Chazal say? What did Yaakov mean? Vihili shoy the Mashiach ben Yosef, vihili chamoy the Mashiach ben David. He is speaking to Esav, Esav Adam Biru, Esav, who wants to kill him, who wants to bite him on his neck. What does he say to Esav? Eret mit dem Weg Mashiachen. Why does he speak with him about, why the Hili Shoi Vachamboi is the union of Mashiach? Because im loven gati, tariag mitzvah shomati. How tariag mitzvah shomati? Because gati, I'm in this world only like a ger, only zeitweilig, only sojourning in this world. This isn't my real place. My real place is Yiddishkeit. My real place is Tariag Mitzvah Shomati. So therefore, when I see a Shoya Chamoy, what do I see? I see Mashiach ben Yosef and I see Mashiach ben David. Nishkein Labav Shetoyre. Madrosh Chazal La La Posuk. That's what we say, V'yeshiv Yaakov be'eretz Megurei Oviv. The center of the coming week. Again, Megurei Oviv. It's Meloshin Ger. Lo yihiglak oshbohu l'Yisrael l'beina umitz el Elohisiv aleim gerim. That why is a Yidin Golus? In order to be Megala, the Netzotzes HaKedusha, which are to be found davke in Golus. That in Golus you find Netzutzus Tutoyu, which have come down in Olam HaTikun. And by being again, Lovengati, one is capable to see beyond the facade, to see beyond the superficial, and to see the essence of everything in the world, which is Elokus, Gedlichkeit, godliness. And that is what the Mashiach is. What's Mashiach? The Rebbe said that we need to ask for Mashiach mit an emes. What means asking for Mashiach mit an emes? Again, we have to have it in context. We have to want to go out, like the Rebbe said in Sicha Yidua, in Koyach Nis and Tov. The Rebbe said, as Madaf Arois came from the Golus HaPnimi in Avodas Hashem. We are in internal exile. Because we're in internal exile, so therefore we see the world externally with the wrong perspective. If we go out from the Golus HaPnim and Avodas Hashem, if we realize the Emes Havai Le'olam, Obloshen HaLocha of the Rambam, Kimo La'oretz Deyos Hashem Kimayim L'yom Echasim, that the Emes and Metzius of Welt is the Lekus, the Aleph and Goyla. So then, when we see a Shoy, when we see a Chamoy, when we go out in the world, we don't see a tank, we don't see a tractor, we see a keli which is capable of letaken olam b'malchus shein dalad yud. We see a world which is waiting for us to tear down the curtain and be megaled elakusha b'olam, and we should see it b'klolus olam b'bias mashiach tzakeinu now.
Agroisi Yashakoyach, Arau Gluck, for your very inspiring, encouraging words, which are very much appreciated. More so that your continuous encouragement and inspiration to all of us here in Beis Mashiach is extremely welcome, and may it continue for many more years. It would be not correct for me to allow this opportunity to go by without making mention of two very important members of this community who unfortunately are no longer with us, the Gashmias. One of the founder members of the shul, Masuda Bas Chaim Nemni, who unfortunately passed away during this year, and we are sure that she is a Melitz Yosher for us, for her family foremost, and for all of us here. And no question about it, she will be ensuring the speedy Iskalus of the Rebbe Melech HaMashiach where she is at this time. Another very important senior member, one of Zikne Anash, and somebody who we treasured greatly as being one, a regular mespalel here in Beis Mashiach, Rebbe Loser Kalman, Ben Rebbe Aaron Tiefenbrunn. And this is a big personal loss for each and every one of us, of course for his family, but for Beis Mashiach as well. And as I said, that I'm sure that he is storming and making sure to speed up the Iskalus of the Rebbe Melech HaMashiach. Without further ado, the moment that you've all been waiting for, there's been a big storm to hear the world-renowned speaker, Rabbi Reuven Wolf, from Los Angeles, United States, who doesn't need long introductions because the airwaves have already heard him and been encouraged by him, and consequently the turnout this evening has demonstrated that fact. So without further ado, let me introduce you to Rabbi Reuven Wolf.
And a student, there is a certain bonding, a connection that takes place. I've been a teacher for many, many years. All little children, high school, adults. And in that connection that is made between the teacher and the student, see, this is referred to as mashpia and mekabel, there's the idea of a deep attachment. It's called the element of yesoid, it's bonding. And if you're really tuning into someone, so you're tuning into their mind, to the way they're thinking. And naturally what happened to me many times as a teacher is with children you become childish. If I speak to Israelis, I start speaking English with an Israeli accent. If I speak to Persians, in Los Angeles a lot of Persians, I'm suddenly speaking, some of my shiurim you'll hear because only three Persian ladies showed up to this year. So it's the deepest chassidus, l'kutei Torah, Torah Oyer, and I'm sounding like a Persian speaking English. So I'm afraid that during our talk tonight, I'm going to start speaking English like an Englishman in with a British accent. Well, that's going to be a little strange, because you have someone from Borough Park, lives in Los Angeles, is a Lubavitcher Meshechist with a Shtreimel, speaking English with a British accent. Something, then you know that's Taka Mashiach Zeiten. In any case, the Alter Rebbe, when he was coming back right after his release from his imprisonment in Petersburg, on his way home, the Alter Rebbe passed through a certain town. And the people came out to greet the Alter Rebbe, and there were chassidim there, and they were dancing in the streets. It was Freilach. And the Alter Rebbe said to the people of that town, I owe you something. When I have a shuldik, I owe you something, and therefore you have a choice. I want to give you something, a debt of gratitude, and the choice is I can either tell you a story, or I can say chassidus. Now, the reason why the Alter Rebbe said to these people that he owes them something, because on the way when the Alter Rebbe was arrested, like close to 2 months before this, when the Alter Rebbe was arrested and he was on his way to Petersburg under a very, very, very heavy armed guard in the infamous black carriage that was reserved only for the worst criminals, the wagon came through this particular town. The head guard, the official who was in charge over the shmira, over the guarding of the wagon, became very thirsty. And he wanted a drink of water. So he stopped the wagon in front of a house, and he went over to knock on the door. It happened to be a Jewish home. The Yid comes to the door. You know, this guy didn't knock too gently. He was a burly Russian commander. Gave him a zetz. And this Yid, poor little, you know, Jew, generally when you heard a knock like that, you're a little worried. But he opened the door, he almost fell chaloshes. Stands in front of him, a big captain from the Russian army or so, and he's terrified. And the man said to him, get me water. Oh, Baruch Hashem, all he needs is water. Okay. So he goes out, he brings him water, and the captain couldn't control himself. And he says to this Yidle, he says, you know who I have over there, huh? Now, I don't know if the news got there that the Alter Rebbe was arrested or what, where, and when, but he said, you know, I have the Grand Rabbi. So this Yid, out of curiosity, like, was sticking out his head and looking, And the Alter Rebbe is looking through the carriage, there's bars, and he's looking through the window that was there, and the Alter Rebbe motions to him to come. So this Yid approached, he got close to the wagon, and the Alter Rebbe said to him, Bistakoyen, nein? Bistakoyen. He said, yeah. The Alter Rebbe said, I need a bracha. Chtafa birchus koyan. And this Yid that gave the Alter Rebbe birchus koyan. A birchus koyan. Then they continued, the Alter Rebbe left, and then he... So the Alter Rebbe felt that he owes a thank you to this community, because in this community, from this Yid, he got a birchus koyanim, and that was part of his shemitah and so forth. So therefore the Alter Rebbe said, you get to choose a story or chassidus. And the Yidden over there in the town were smart, and they said, a story. So the Alter Rebbe said to them as follows. The Baal Shem Tov, the Zayde, the Baal Shem Tov, the Alter Rebbe used to refer to the Baal Shem Tov as the Zayde, that the Baal Shem Tov once heard or knew that the Satan has the key to the Geula. The key, the Shlissel, to the Geula, to the Geula Shalema, is in the hands of the Satan. What's the key of the Geula doing in the hands of the Satan? The Satan has to give us up this. What does he have to do with the Geula? So the Alter Rebbe said, it's because when it came time for the second Beis HaMikdash to be destroyed, the Satan didn't let them destroy the Bayis Sheni. Why would the Satan care for the destruction of the Bayis Sheni? Not Allah has, it would be the opposite, contrary. That should have been, that's Koma Avoyei of the Satan. He wants the destruction of holiness. That's what he's been working for all the time, to diminish the presence of the Eivishter in the world and holiness in the world. Of course, he wanted the destruction. So the reason why he didn't want to let it happen, because he felt that he was cheated once, and he was not going to be cheated a second time. What was the story? When it came time, the first Beis HaMikdash was destroyed by Churban Bayis Rishon. Initially, the Avedis, Chas V'Sholem, of Yidden was so severe that it was deserving, Chas V'Sholem, to be a Kiloyan, Chas V'Sholem, a time when there should, that all Yidden should have, Chas V'Sholem, been annihilated. Navaz then, as the Gemara tells us, Shafach HaMasoy al Eitzim V'Alavonim. The Eivishter exchanged it. He destroyed the Beis HaMikdash. That's why it says Mizmar Liyosov. There's a Mizmar, there's a Shida that the Beis HaMikdash was destroyed, because that's what saved the Bnei Yisrael. And the Satan went along with it. Even though he was expecting Chas V'Sholem, a destruction of all the Bnei Yisrael, but the Seifas Beis HaLekeinu was so bad that he was able to accept it as an exchange. But what the Satan didn't hear was that it was only going to be for 70 years. It turned out 70 years later, they came back and they built the Beis HaMikdash, so he felt that he was ripped off. So therefore, when it came time for the second Beis HaMikdash destroyed, he put down his foot and he said, Bushum Oifenem. So they, in order to be able to, you know, to work it out, so the Eivishter said to the Satan, don't worry, this time it's for a long time. The Satan wasn't accepting it. So the Eivishter said, you know what? I'll give you the key to the Geula. And you have the key. And therefore you can be assured that that's not going to come before you're ready. Fine. As a result of that, the Baal Shem Tov, whose inyan is as Neshama came to the world in order to pave the way for Bias HaMashiach, the Baal Shem Tov wanted to get that key. In order to receive the key, the only way to do that is he's got to bring the Satan down here in this world. No, the Baal Shem Tov knows what he has to do. So the Baal Shem Tov started doing all kinds of piyulas in order to draw down the Satan down here into this world. The Baal Shem Tov was warned Milmaila that it's very dangerous, that he should stop, and that it's something that perhaps he shouldn't do. See, we're just talking about it, and it's already smoking. Say, it's already, he's already. So they told the Baal Shem Tov, the truth is, I could use those perks in a few moments when we get very dramatic that the Satan is descending, okay? So if you can just... In any case, it so happened, so the Baal Shem Tov ignored it, and the Baal Shem Tov continued doing whatever he needed to do to bring the Satan down. And lo and behold, the Satan appeared. It was a very, very frightening moment. And the Satan turned to the Heilig of Baal Shem Tov and he said to him, "How dare you? How dare you, little human being made out of flesh and blood? How dare you disturb my comfort up there when I haven't been down here on earth only 3 times in the history of the world? I was down here. All the other times I get my work done through my agents, through my hitmen. They do the work for me, but there was only 3 times in history that I myself came down because it was too crucial that I had to make sure to be there myself. And when was that? The first one was during the Chet of the Eitz Hadas. The Satan himself came down to earth. The second one was during the Chet HaEgel. And the third one was by the Churban Bayis Rishon. The first Beis HaMikdash, the Satan himself came down to help out pouring the kerosene or whatever is needed to be done to make sure that the Beis HaMikdash would be destroyed. And therefore, how dare you not be afraid of me? So the Baal Shem Tov, the Heilige Baal Shem Tov said to him, "Mr. Satan, listen. I was a little boy, maybe not just about 3 years old, when my father, the Tzaddik Rebbe Eliezer, was laying on his deathbed. And I was standing right next to him, and he took my little hand. And my father, my saintly father, Rebbe Eliezer, said to me, 'Hob lib ayeder yid mit the flam fire from thine neshama. Love every Jew with the flaming, burning love of your innermost of your soul.' In Hopfim Kenan Nishkaimoida Oysed Rebishter, don't be afraid of anybody else. And therefore the Baal Shem Tov says, 'I don't fear you. Now give me the key.' Anyways, what exactly happened, I don't know, but somehow the Baal Shem Tov got the key from out of the Satan in that encounter. And that was the end of the story. That's the story the Alter Rebbe said to the Chassidim that were out there when he was returning from Peterburg and he left. The Zikna Chassidim who heard the Maisa thought about it and they explained that what really the Alter Rebbe was saying is that the key that the Baal Shem Tov was talking about was the neshama of the Alter Rebbe. The Alter Rebbe was talking about himself. And that he is the key to the Geula Shalema. And that neshama was being blocked somehow, whatever that means, that the Satan was able to stop that neshama from coming into the world. And it was the Baal Shem Tov that wrestled the neshama of the Alter Rebbe down to this world. As we know that when the Alter Rebbe was born, the Baal Shem Tov made us, even just, the Baal Shem Tov made a big, he made a suddah, made a whole thing in his amongst his Talmidim. He said, because the tremendous Yom Simcha, that a neshama chadash is coming to the world. A new neshama. Now, most of the people think when we talk about a new neshama means a neshama that hasn't been around the block. We're all recycled. We've been around more than once. And then from time to time comes a new neshama that hasn't been here before. But if you learn Lakutei Torah, I think it is in Parshas Tzav, in a maimer v'chaltem, and if the maimer starts with achaltem ochel, yeah, could be that's the maimer. Over there, the Alter Rebbe brings from the Arizal, and you can look it up, I think, in Shara Gilgulim or in Sefer Gilgulim, where the Arizal talks about the idea of what does it mean in Neshama Chadash. And he says like this, that all Neshamas are a chelik from Adam Arishin's Neshama. All Neshamas. So therefore, any Neshama that comes to the world is not really a Neshama Chadash. Because every Neshama was here already as a chelik of Adam Arishin's Neshama. It's Yedua, what Reb Zusha asked Rebbe Lemelech. It's Yedua, this what Reb Zusha asked Rebbe Lemelech. Reb Zusha said to the Heilige Rebbe Lemelech, "Deveistach, it's like the Bishleim, every single person went around, was able to sin with the Chet Eitz Hadas, so B'dir Meilech, man Heilige Brider, you're such a Yirah Shemayim, how did you go along with the Chet of the Eitz Hadas?" And Rebbe Lemelech answered that it says, if you can eat, you're going to be Yoidei Toiv. You're going to be Yoidei Elokim. You're going to be know how to. So the Melech said, it's better to eat and find out that you're not an Eibish there than to walk around all the time to think that you maybe would one day, if you would eat from that, you'll be able to be born. That's what the Melech said. But all Neshamas are a chelik of Adam Arishin. The Arizal says that after Mashiach comes, new neshamas are going to come into the world, and their getlichkeit, the level of these neshamas, is going to be way, way, way above, way superior to any other neshamas, and those are the new souls of the future. So generally, those neshamas are only coming down when Mashiach comes, but there is one exception. Says, a future soul, a soul that doesn't even belong to our days, a neshama that's completely about the future. And therefore, when you learn Chassidus Chabad, you learn Torah Oir, you learn Tikkuti Torah, you learn Tanya, you're learning the simcha, the joy that it causes, the deep place that it excites within you is just unbelievable, because it picks you up and it literally elevates you from the very, very existence that we know, and it puts you in touch with something so real, so exquisite, so unbelievably beautiful, sweet, and delicious. And that's the future light. The light of Yemos HaMashiach. That's the Alter Rebbe's neshama. But we takan know, if you look at the Seder Ishtal Shalis Advarim, why did that neshama chadasha punkt come down dafka at that time? By the way, another thing, we know the father, Heilige Ruziner, his father was Reb Shalom of Provich. The Heilige Reb Shalom of Provich was as a son of Reb Avram HaMalach. He had a father, a Malach. So Reb Shalom, when the Alter Rebbe went out of in jail on Yutes Kislev, so Reb Shalom said right then, he stood where he was far away, and he said, "Today Reb Shneur Zalman is a Ruski Gangen." That Reb Shneur Zalman just went out of jail. So they asked him, "How do you know?" So he says, "Because it says in Zohar that when Mashiach comes, the you're going to see the rainbow. There's going to be a keshes ba'ampeni hidden." The rainbow is going to be displayed in a way that it's going to be full of brilliant light. He says, "I saw that rainbow today, and since Mashiach didn't come, it must be that Shneur Zalman went out of jail." But hold it, if it's supposed to only come when Mashiach comes, how is it that it's shining when the Alter Rebbe goes out of jail? And the answer is because Hainahach, the Alter Rebbe is going out of jail is Bias HaMashiach. Because Bias HaMashiach comes in stages. And one of the stages of Bias HaMashiach is Yutes Kislev. That's when it's another stage in Bias HaMashiach. But to appreciate this and to understand this a little better, so we go back to the very, very, the beginning of time. When we go back to the very, very early beginning of time, the first story we read in the Torah is the story of the 6 days of creation. Bereishis bara Elokim es haShamayim ves haAretz, the 6 days of creation. So take a look. This is something that is discussed in the Rishonim, the Ramban, and Rabbeinu Bechaya, and Abar Benel, and then there's Arichus Gedoyl, I think, in the Shulah HaKadosh, and the Al-Shech HaKadosh. They all speak about the same Inyan. And that is, and the Vilna Goyen talks about it a lot, that the 6 days of creation correspond to the sixth millennium. To the six Shis Al-Fishnin Heva Alma, there's 6,000 years that the world stands. And the 6,000 years every day corresponds to one of the 1,000 years. And it's amazing, if you learn, even just in the Rishonim, forget about it if you start learning the more Kabbalistic relationship of the Kabbalah, and so you'll see unbelievable parallels. What happened, the 6 days of creation, it's literally the Eibishter that maps out the entire history in Parshas Bereishis. But over there, you go through the story, and you come to Yom HaShishi, the sixth day. What happened on Friday? So on Friday, Adam HaRishon is created. Adam HaRishon is really the true Adam, who is Adam Elyon, the ultimate human being, is really Melech HaMashiach. He is the ultimate Adam. Adam actually stands for, it says in Ol Svarim, Adam David Mashiach. So Adam is really Mashiach. And when is he created? He's created on Friday. Because this man of Be'ita, this man of the time of Bias HaMashiach, is really on Friday. It's a very interesting Zohar which I came across. It says Rebbe Elazar and Reb Shimon was going together with Rebbe Eliezer, his Rebbe. And Reb Shimon asked Rebbe Eliezer, he said to him, "Rebbe, how come the human being was created last? Everybody was created, and Adam HaRishon was only created on the sixth, on Friday." So his Rebbe Eliezer answered him so that the human should not be able to claim take credit that he was a partner with the Eibishter in creating the world. So therefore the Eibishter made sure that everybody should be there before Adam, and they should see that Adam was created later. So you shouldn't fadrei anybody a cop that he was involved in creating them. Fine. Then Rabbi Eliezer stops and he starts crying. It wasn't Rabbi Shimon, it was Rabbi Akiva. So Rabbi Akiva says to Rabbi Eliezer, his Rebbe, why are you crying? Was veinst du, Rebbe? So he says, on the shaila that you asked me, I am crying. Because a vision, I saw right now a vision, and it's very painful. He says, what's the vision? He says that the person who is Osiyem Anane Shamaya, the person we've been all been waiting for, the one that's coming on the clouds, which is Mashiach Tzidkenu, he is not going to arrive until the Bishtisa in the sixth millennium. He's only going to come on Friday. That's the idea of the creation of Adam really means the making of Mashiach. And it's not going to come to Friday. But this is what he said, Avol b'loi, not at the end. That means the Yidden who say, most first are so excited, Lubavitch with Mashiach. Maybe we still have another 221 years till Elef Hashishis. Ken noch zan and zwei hindet yur. You know, it can be still another 200 years till it's going to happen. But it's not true. Mashiach is not supposed to come in Elef Hashvi'i. Mashiach's reign, his malchus, is Elef Hashishi. This is his time. And he comes, it says there in the Zohar, le'itakin oilam, to prepare the world to be able to get ready for Shabbos. The world is at tzedrei tevelt. The world is not ready for the giluyim of Yom Yisrael Mashiach. So Mashiach comes to fix the world, to fix humanity, to fix people, to be able to receive Yom Yisrael Mashiach, to be able to receive the giluy of Shabbos. So that happens on Friday. Therefore, it says, now what do we do on Shabbos? And that's all hachana for the great day of Shabbos. And what Shabbos? Shabbos is a day of kulay dveikus in the Eibishter. So from the year 6000 and then onward is going to be a time of yom shekulay Shabbos for the world. What do we do on Shabbos? We do a lot of things on Shabbos, especially chsedim, aroisik, and davening, and fabreng, and that. But the mitzvah of Shabbos is oynik Shabbos. Shabbos darf man essen kigel mit gefilte fish mit alle andere gitte sachen. Does not mean on Shabbos. Shabbos, you have to eat. That's the mitzvah. Now we know, and everybody's familiar with the concept and with the idea, that in order, that from achila of Shabbos, you have to have toya mehel. You have to taste from the food of Shabbos. So that's an Indian. And those that are mahadr, and those, like it's like Hanukkah, there is mahadr, and then there is mahadr, and mina mahadr, and there's various different levels in this Indian. When exactly you can start toya mehel from when we were in yeshiva, we used to go on Memen Slobotka. There was a place in Bnei Berak, Feshen Vidal Sizov, Gamach, Bin Tzvei Geri Yungalait, and Gamach Nazat Shul and Tesli. And we used to go from yeshiva, and I remember till today that once I started learning Tanya, I was in Slobotka, Bnei Berak, and I got to the Prokem, we were dealing with a Skafia. I had such a mocham inside of me, because it was such a yishmak that we would go Thursday night to eat chont, but then I felt like a chazer, geistach donishtik nach, geistach vixetz netchim chont, and this and that. But my nafsha Bahamas prevailed over my nafsha Zolikis, and I continued that minig. But I'm just letting. But that was, at least there was a struggle when I was learning Tanya. I had the fight that was going on inside of me. But there's different levels. When do you start Toyamel? So you can start Shabbos b'chatzois, and then those earlier. The Rebbe of Shabbos, a very interesting mimer, says that the etzem Friday morning, it's already a zman for Toyamel. I don't want to give anybody ideas, the first thing you do Friday morning. But in any case, there is a Toya Me already Friday in the morning. So now but what does it mean? Let's get a little deeper a second. What does it mean when Mashiach will come? There is going to be, everybody knows, Mashiach comes, it talks about in Gemara all over, Tzvetzayin HaSuda, and there's going to be Shoyd HaBoyer, and the Leviyasin, and Methum HaSida, it's going to be unbelievable. Obviously, No matter how we're going to describe the Leviyasin, this is such a fish, unbelievable fish. We can make from them gefilte fish, we can make from them lox, and we can make from them all the mina herring, Stiglitz herring, and Schmaltz herring, and this kind of herring. And I wouldn't be surprised if we'll have a sushi stand also from the Leviyasin. Today's days, people are going to be very disappointed if we don't have sushi. So I'm sure the Leviyasin is a big fish. It's going to provide everything. But obviously, we all understand that is extremely, and I'm not taking it away from anybody, because of those of Yidden have been excited already all this time waiting for the Leviyasin. We all understand that Yidden have not been persecuted and butchered and exterminated and gone through thousands of years of blood and oceans of tears. For what? For a gitten shtickle fleish and a shtickle fleish. So we understand that there is something much deeper in the Shoyer Aboyd and the Leviathan. So the Rebbe Rishab explains what this really means is the gilui of Soydis HaTorah. Pnimius HaTorah is going to be revealed. I hope no one gets disappointed. But when Mashiach is going to come, there's going to be such a gilui of Pnimius HaTorah, and that's called eating. What's the Shaychus? Why is it called eating? Because when you learn, when you eat something, the pleasure of eating is unique. What happens when you eat? The food is first on the plate, then the food enters your body, and it becomes part of you. All the good stuff in the food becomes part of you. It gets absorbed by the body, the nutrients go in, the vitamins, the bones get the calcium, this gets to that. It becomes basar, damu basar kipsare. When you study something, when you learn something, when your brain processes information, it also takes the idea and it eats it because it becomes part of your psyche. It becomes of who you are. It's the gesnapis. That's why learning and understanding is also called eating. So in Yomaisa Mashiach and Elef Ashvi, there is going to be an abundance of giloy of Pnimiyas HaTorah. Why is it Shoyer Aboyd and the Leviathan? So the Rebbe Rishab explains that there are two types. The Macholim is created from our work during Golos. We create the Leviathan. We create the Shoyer Aboyd. We develop it. Or if we don't create it, we cook it. We prepare it. And who are the ones who do the Avoid? The Rebbe Rishab explains there's two types of neshamas. There are neshamas that are called Nuneyama, they're fish neshamas. And there are neshamas that are called Shoyer Aboyd. Fish neshamas are neshamas of big tzaddikim who are bottled to the Eibishter all the time. And therefore, they're compared to fish. Fish is one with the ocean. And then there is Shoyer Aboyd, means animals, more like a behema. And that means like the regular people like us, regular folks like us, who live outside of Elokus. Our reality is ourselves. Our reality is the chumrius of this world. We struggle to overcome our Yetzahara. We struggle to overcome our temptations and earthly physical cravings to do what the Yevishter wants. So we're compared more like the animal, not like the fish. And we know Taket says that when tzaddikim are Magugu, they come in fish. One of the chassidim of, I think, the Alter Rebbe was eating, one of the big chassidim, he ate a fish and suddenly he's going to stick in the throat. And he started choking, and the Alter Rebbe said, "No, nishta yed, fish daf mevisim visa to essen. Fish you need, and the neshamas daf mevisim visa. It's not everybody can deal with fish. In any case, so fish is a different type. So this creates the Shoyer Aboyd and the Leviathan. But before the giluyim that happen when Mashiach comes, we have to start tasting the food. So when do we taste? We spoke about on Friday. So if you take this time in general, and you divide the 6,000 years, so when do you have Friday? In by us in our Yiddish calendar, first is night, and then is day. So if you take 1,000 years, 500 is night, 500 is day. So translate that into, so an Elef HaShishi begins when, in the secular calendar, it's the year 1240. 1240 is the beginning of Elef HaShishi. 500 years, knock off, that's night. 1740, Tof Kuf, Shnas Tof Kuf, that's the beginning of Elef, that's the beginning of morning, of day, of Erev Shabbos, which you can start eating Macholi Shabbos. So, but let's for a moment stop for a moment. Did anybody over here ever try this make a achlata decision that I'm going to learn Shas, right? I know, you probably, people learn Shas, I'm going to dafayim. I probably made that achlata like 26 times. And I usually didn't get too far. I try, okay, you know, everybody's entitled to try. But brachas, you know, at least you go through the first few prakim and brachas, until the, anyways, the Gemara, this is why it's a Gemara that everybody's familiar with. The Gemara says, Shloisha chelka halayla, the night has three chalok. And the first night, the first third of the night, chamoyer, noyer, a donkey brays. Second third of the night, klovim, tzoyakim, dogs are barking. And the third of the night, tinik yoinik mishtei imoy, a child is nursing from his mother, the isha mesaperes and baila, and a woman is talking to her husband. So Rashi says, why is the woman talking to, what's happening over there, the tinik yoinik? Because the baby went to sleep. The mother put the baby to sleep at 6 o'clock in the evening. It's already 4 o'clock in the morning. The baby's hungry. And he wakes up crying. So the mother has to feed the baby. Isha Mesapetis and Baila. Why? Because people are waking up already. It's morning. It's getting close to dawn. People are waiting. See, today's days we're used to being up late at night because we have all technology. Fleck them all nine that it's a learn tinkle. He hear like it's unbelievable. Shabbos is 3:40. It's nice by 5 o'clock. Everybody used to be sleeping already. And there was the teen. Malain tali sepidim edefet ostein as a dry as I in the free. Wasn't such a big deal. Today everybody's up still checking out their WhatsApps till like 1 o'clock in the morning. But then it wasn't that way. So people would wake up very early. So people isham esaperes and baila tinek yoinik mishteimai gevaldik. So the Rebbe Rashab says an amazing thing. That night that the Gemara is talking about the 500 years from the year 1240 to the year 1740. What happened then? So let's take 2/3. If you take 500 divided into 3/3, it's 166. 3 times 166 and a third is 500. So 2 times 166 gives you 333. 333 years from the beginning of Elef HaShishi Shnas Sheleg. That's when the baby is hungry and the baby wants the nurse. So the Rebbe Rashab says, you know what happened then? Shnas Sheleg, in a little shtetl, a little town, in the northern part of Eretz Yisrael, on a hilltop in the city, the holy city of Tzvas, suddenly appeared, just for 2 years, a tzaddik, unbelievable, that changed the face of Pnimius HaTorah, the Heilig Arizal, appeared in Shnas Sheleg. And he was only teaching for 2 years. Kol Kisvei Ari, everything we have is from those 2 years of the Ari. Any case, the Ari HaKadosh, he says. So what is the deeper meaning? Tinik, he says, is Knesset Yisrael, the Jewish people. We're the Tinik, we're the child. We are hungry. We haven't eaten. We haven't had Gilui HaLukus already for 1,500 years. The baby is starving. The mother, we were back when we were in Eretz Yisrael, we had Nevuah, we had Gilui HaLukus in the Beis HaMikdash, we were nourished, we were nurtured. And the baby, we were starved, and the poor baby wakes up and he's hungry. So the mother is nursing. The nursing is not real food yet. Because before you can eat food, your stomach is not ready yet to receive food. So the stomach needs to be given just nursing, this prepares the kishkis, and then later the baby gets developed after at least 2 years, it can start eating food. So the gilui of the Arizal was the giluyim of Yomayis HaMashiach, but in a manner of chalav and the mother. That's why he says also isha mesaperes in baila means that we're not in galus alone. Our mother, which is the Shechina, is also in galus along with us. Isha mesaperes in baila means that for the 15 years since the Churban Beis HaMikdash, the Eibishter, we're going to show them bias problems. The Eibishter and the Shechina were not talking. There was a separation. Now what happened? He starts communicating. The Eibishter is talking to the Shechina again. So you'd see an amazing thing. What happened? Who was living in those days in Tzvas? First of all, it was like unbelievable. But one of the great people living in Tzvas was Reb Shlaim Alkavitz. And what do we have from him? We have Lecha Doidi. So take a look, it's an amazing thing, you know that all communities are different minhagim. The meaning of singing Lecha Doidi Friday night is Neskabel B'chol Tzvutzis Yisrael. Doesn't make a difference if you're Moroccan Jews, you're Yemenite Jews, you're Yekeshi Yid, no matter who it is, everybody integrated Lecha Doidi into their... So there's something very deep over here. Why was it created dafka at that time? Take a look at the Chodaydi. What does it say over there? It says, "Isnadi me'afar kumi, shake yourself off from the dirt. Lifshi bigdei svarti chami, dress yourself already in the clothing for the Gula." Imagine if Shlomo Malkavitz is talking 400 something years ago, and he's already excited. It's not just talking about Pnei Shabbos Nekabla means we're going to this Shabbos. Every Shabbos is Me'ein Moshiach. Pnei Shabbos Nekabla means the ultimate Shabbos, Yom Shekulei Shabbos. We have to start getting ready at that time. His oidity, his oidity, kiva oidech, your light is coming. Unbelievable. But that was only nursing. And then, when it becomes crack of dawn, it becomes morning, Aloysa Shachar, that's the year 1740. So what happened in 1740? In the year 1733, 7 years before 1740, a tzaddik nister, known as Reb Yisroel Baal Shem, reveals himself 7 years before the turn of the century, when the morning of Elef HaShvi, when it becomes Friday morning, Vert Nesgala de Baal Shem Tov Offenfeld. And suddenly the European Jewry is swept up in a frenzy, a new energy, a new life likewise we've never seen before. The Baal Shem Tov suddenly was Machaya Mesim, Atzomis Hayavashis, Dugin Oisketrikin, came the Baal Shem Tov. And also it's a Chiddush Nifla, because we know how cautious Yidden are to any new phenomenon. Anybody comes, one of the basic principles didn't start with the Chassam Sofer, Chudosh Usam and Atoyra. Chudosh Usam and Atoyra is already, I mean, Baal Shem, the Chassam Sofer put it to the words, to this halacha, but Yidden are very suspicious. And especially after Shabbosai Tzvi. Especially. And Taka de Misnagdim, Taka were fighting because of that. But yet to believe that Yidden Talmidei Chachamim, Yidden Geoinim, Tzadikim, there was one stam at Pesach Veis, he came to some Chveis, a little Chevra of Batlanim over there, and he gave them the Baal Shem Tov at Ibeginim in Yiddishkeit, literally swept across Poland and Galicia and Hungary and Ukraine and Russia and Lithuania. I mean, even all communities. And in a very short period of time. Very short. And that's because you can see that this is a getliche zach. This is not stam. It's not a human movement. It's something godly. It's because the time has come for the giloy of Mashiach to reach the world. The Baal Shem Tov starts teaching Pnimiyas HaTorah. By the way, Friday, Adam is the concept. Friday is Pikabala, Friday is connected to Yesoid. And we know the concept called Yesoid Tzaddik, that the union of Tzaddik is related to Yesoid. To the Baal Shem Tov, you're going to see there wasn't the concept of Tzaddik in the world. There were Nevi'im, there were Ga'onim, they weren't called, besides Yosef HaTzaddik or Shimon HaTzaddik, very few. Generally, everybody, and the relationship wasn't an oifen of iskashrus. What does Yesoid mean? We spoke earlier. Yesoid means bonding. This idea that people become so infatuated with a certain individual and their whole life starts becoming about that person and they're so pulled and they have such ava, such a iskashrus, such a deep connection, is a new thing. It didn't exist. Why? Because the Baal Shem Tov, the ultimate Yesoid Tzaddik is Adam Arishon, and this is Mashiach Tzidkenu, and the Baal Shem Tov is the beginning of that inyan. So he reintroduces that concept to the world. But as the Rebbe Rishab continues, and he says, no, the Baal Shem Tov was only Alois HaShachar, and then is Netzach Hama, the sunrise. Api Alochi goes through exactly, it's an hour and 12 minutes after. So he goes through how many years it is, I think it's 52 years. So what happens by 52 years later after Tav Kuf? Mamish 52 years, Tav Kuf Nun Beis. If you take a look in the Hayoim Yoim, in the introduction of Hayoim Yoim, he gives a list of what happened with the Alter Rebbe all the years. Tav Kuf Nun Beis is Pashta Toides Chassidus Chabad in an incredible way. So he says, because, well, what's the Inyan? The Inyan is because it comes Alois HaShachar. Not Alois HaShachar, Netzach Hama. Vos Daf Min Tam Ba Netzach Hama. Daf Leini Krishma. So you need someone to give you a Mashiachtiga understanding in Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad, as Yidden Zon Kenen Zugen, Krishma Shal Shachris, the Krishma of Mashiach. If you take a look at the Alter Rebbe's Maimarim, come out every Maimar, what does the Alter Rebbe explain? The Alter Rebbe explains, Yechud Eilah, Yechud Datar, he explains the concept of Echad, as a Yidzo Fershtein, that Einoid Movado Imamish in a Seichel, how all the Oilamois, the Ches and the Dalid, are bottled to the Aleph, and Einoid Movado, and that's the Chiddush of the, and that's the Chiddush of the Baal Shem Tov, of the Alter Rebbe. So you see, it's Alois, it's Kriya Shema Shal Shachas. All right, what happens in Chab, what continues? Bechlau Chassidus revolutionized Europe, and then it spread beyond Europe, and there's a simcha, and there is Avos Yisroel, and song comes back to Yidden, and dancing comes back into Yiddishkeit. This is all, so you have to appreciate and understand that the Hasidic movement, as I put it, it's a modern word to use, Hasidic movement, I don't like the word. The ganze Hasidische Hasidus, the whole thing, at its core, This is frightening, okay? Don't get scared. At its core, really don't get scared. At its core, it's messianic, okay? Messianic is a scary word. It's Mashiachtig, okay. It's a Mashiachtig movement. That's what it was. That's what it was at the beginning, and that's what it's going to be till the very end. It's a Mashiachtig movement. Now, what happened? Chassidus Tzitzik Fashbreit, but there's one kreis, Chassidus Chabad, that plays a unique role. The Alter Rebbe doesn't just have Chassidus HaBaal Shem Tov, he takes it a step further, which means he starts taking the Yonim that the Baal Shem Tov revealed, the Elukus. The Baal Shem Tov brought down Elukus, uncovered rather, we should say, Elukus in the world, and the Alter Rebbe started taking Elukus and processing it into the human mind. It's an absolute contradiction for the human mind to be able to behold infinity, that which is Ein Sof. It doesn't make any sense. It can't be. Yet the Alter Rebbe did the impossible, because that's what the Eibishter wants. There should be a chibur of gvul and bli gvul. So the Alter Rebbe began Chassidus Chabad, and boy, oh boy, did the Alter Rebbe take the heat. The Talmidim of the Magid themselves were misnagid to the Alter Rebbe. A lot of them, he had some defenders. The Kozhnitz of Magid defended the Alter Rebbe. The Heilige Bardichev defended the Alter Rebbe. But boy on boy, Rabbi Avram Kalisker and Rabbi Baruchel of Mezhebuzh and others were mamish fighting against them. And this caused the Alter Rebbe so much grief, so much pain, much more than the Isnagdus that was coming from the Vilna Gaon. This was his own friends that came against him, because how are you doing that? But the Alter Rebbe was saying, as long as Elokus remains only in your Emuna, as long as Elokus doesn't permeate you in your very being, then you and it are two. And then Eibishter has not become one with you. The purpose of creation is, as mi nizgale everywhere, there shouldn't be an akuda in the world. There shouldn't be a place in the world that is not fully permeated with the emes Hashem li olam. For that, we have to start with what? We start with the highest part of the human being, and that's this human seichel. Medarf machen de seichel elokus. So the Alter Rebbe did that. It's interesting, I'll tell you a very interesting thing. I heard this recently. The Ruzhina, the Heilige Ruzhina, said as follows. He said, why is it that the Rebbe Baruch Hu of Mezhebuzh hat chazoi loichem gewen, kegen dem Alten Rebbe, against the Alter Rebbe's revealing of Pnimius HaTorah? So Rebbe Baruch Hu said like this. It is known that when the Baal Shem Tov stood in Heichal HaMashiach, and they told the Baal Shem Tov, L'kshiafutzum and Eisech HaChutzah, that's where Mashiach is going to come, the Baal Shem Tov had gelost Tzvei Tren. The Baal Shem Tov was crying when he heard that. Some people think that the tears were because when is that going to be already? The Baal Shem Tov felt like, oi, when can that happen? That's too long. But really, the reason why it hurt him is because Chassidus is a lakus. And Megate Nemen Chassidus, and you're going to bring it chutzah, you're going to bring it into the gutter, you're going to bring Chassidus to people, nish to Talmid Baal Shem Tov, Heilige Yidden, but you're going to bring Chassidus to hippies, you're going to bring Chassidus to people that are Bechlau not. You know, there are people, I know Yidden, tired of Yidden. They shudder, they just cannot believe, they're so uncomfortable when they would hear someone like me speaking in English. Vikit English, a trifen illusion. Tzeredna lekismet in English. That doesn't make any sense. To any sensitive Hungarian Jew, he hears that there's something there, but he can't make peace with it. Because it doesn't, and the Baal Shem Tov is also crying. Because where's the sensitivity? But Tzayf, Chassidus has to come everywhere. So the Heilige Ruzhiner said like this, Rebbe Baruch Hu, who was a physical enekel for the Alter Rebbe, he was a physical enekel, erot gizhalevit zaydis tren. He had bothered, it hurt him, the Baal Shem Tov's tears, and he felt for his zaydis pain. The Alter Rebbe was a ruchniestige enekel, and he just knew that he needs to get the job done. So even though it was painful for the Baal Shem Tov, obesoif kol soif, emesai kosimar, we have no breda. Chassidus has to come and spread across the world. So this was the Alter Rebbe, and then came seven generations. The Mittel Rebbe took Chassidus of the Alter Rebbe and made Rechoyves Anor, Espashtus, unbelievable. The Alter Rebbe spoke Chassidus for an hour. The Mittel Rebbe spoke Chassidus for 6 hours, 7 hours, 8 hours. Last week, there was the story that I read a long time ago, but I reread it again. The Rebbe Marash once asked his brother, the Kapuster, Verwassert man die geriefen der Ständer. The Kapuster, if you the label of Kapuster, hat man geriefen der Ständer. They called him, the Chassidim referred to him as the Ständer. They asked, why do they call you the Ständer? So he says, because the Zayde, the Mittler Rebbe, would go out in the field and held on to him and leaned on him and said Chassidus. So he says, but how many hours did he say Chassidus on you? So he says, one time he said Chassidus for 2 hours. He said, nah, fadema b'dach nishkerif in the Ständer. Tell me how long he said. He said, one time he said Chassidus for 4 hours. He said, fadema b'dach nishkerif in the Ständer. Tell me how long. And it went on and on. 6 hours, 8 hours. He didn't let him off the hook. And then the Kapuster says, "Vus dar, why do you need to know this?" I don't remember exactly the answer, but basically he says, "Minigeya." So then he admitted to him that one time the Mittler Rebbe said Chassidus, holding on to the Kapuster, I think 18 hours. Can you imagine that? State the Mittler Rebbe in Gist Chassidus for 18 shoe. You know, you take a look at a Maimer from the Alter Rebbe, it's one page in Torah Or, a page and a half. 2 pages. Take a look at the same Maimer in Teiras Chaim from the Mittler Rebbe. It's a whole book. Mamish, it's 40, 50 pages. So the Mittler Rebbe took Chassidus, wow. Then came the Tzemach Tzedek. And then a special milestone was the Rebbe Rashab. He took Chassidus into a whole new level of Havana. He made Chassidus so much more humanly understandable. If you learn the Maimarim of Samach Vav and the Rebbe Marash, the Rebbe Shab's Maimarim, they're far more chewable. You can chew it with your mind much more. And the Alter Rebbe is, it's still Lehecher. Then, but this was all a preparation. Bisigikum and Doit Hashvi. Came the seventh generation. When they came the seventh generation, the Rebbe's Oilal Kesan Asiyas, on the first day on Yud Shvat, and the Rebbe says, Amaimir Bos, Ilagan, Yachol Yisikalo. And the Rebbe starts a Maimer where he's talking that there are 7 tzaddikim, and these 7 tzaddikim have a job. These are the 7 tzaddikim that are compared to the first 7 tzaddikim. Just like way back then, when the Eibishter, at the beginning, the first time the Eibishter revealed himself to Bnei Yisrael, to Yidden, took us out of Mitzrayim, and there were 7 tzaddikim, beginning with Avraham Avinu, and they each one brought the Shechina down lower and lower. To Moshe Rabbeinu Shu Hashvi. And he's the one who completes the job. So the Rebbe on the first Maimer, when he's accepting, and this is like kind of his statement, his mission statement, to Chassidei Chabad, and he says, our job is that we're the Doir HaShvi, and our job is to complete the work of Erodes HaShchina Lamata Ba'aretz. In other words, our job is to bring the Geula completely. That's our avodah. Anybody that's heard that Maimer and listened closely is clearly hearing and seeing that the Rebbe is saying that I'm the seventh one, and I'm in the place of Moshe Rabbeinu, and my job is, with you, all of you together, to do the work, and then what is it going to happen? And we are going to, and I, this is the Rebbe, he can't say I, he's talking about him, the Rebbe the Shver, and so on and so forth. This is our job, to complete the work, and be a Samashiach, and that means clearly the Rebbe is Mashiach. B'kach hayod gansen esiyas started, and as I mentioned, I know some heard when I spoke at the Kinnis last year, the Rebbe did things that no Chassidish Rebbe ever did. Keimel nish gehet gevorna such things. The Rebbe puts an army, and he has tanks, and he has neshek, and he has Neder Shabbos. And Tzibet, I mean, the whole Halach Yelech is so revolutionary and so strange. And that's why the Rebbe is always getting esnagdos. He's always, finally, when anybody gets comfortable with him at something that he's doing, I remember my grandmother. My grandmother, Polish, she used to love telling me stories of Rebbe Lamaylich, this and that. She was so upset when I came to Lubavitch. And she was, damn it, the Balachivas, where'd you hit from the Balachivas? Those cats in your skin, damn, I'm Mala, man. She used to yell at me. Unbelievable woman. It's interesting. She's a real Chassidish lady. She was born on Chaf Aleph Adar, and she passed away on Chaf Aleph Adar, on the Bramelech Yartze. And anyways, I hope now she has a little nachas, but then she has had a hard time with me. In any case, the Rebbe's, and then, you know, we finally get comfortable with the Balachivas. The Rebbe starts with Shevem Mitzvah Noach. Lashinupas the Gezein Amas. So failed nish things to do in the Haraidische Welt, failed nish ka problemen. Am hot beste gunish wussetin zu gein sichem goyim. Who ever heard of these things? So strange. You know, last week, I'll give you another example. I talk a lot about Mashiach, and I need to keep updated with it. That's the only reason I look in the news site. Sirotza, because Chabkunish mit Kamis. I'm a daftach kibber. So last week I saw an article in Vosses Night. No one learned from me, please don't. You don't need the internet, you don't need, but okay. So I looked at an article in Vosses Night. There was a news article talking about, there's a person, a Lubavitch, I don't know who, and he made 30,000, he built 30,000 menorahs, public menorahs. Okay, in the moment I see there's an article in Vosses Night about Lubavitch building 30,000 menorahs, I know already what the tekuvot are going to be, but when I want to get my blood pressure up, I decide to read those 13, 15 comments, whatever they are. The comments, and I'm waiting for the Oy B'chochem. I know the Oy B'chochem is coming. More than one. There'll be quite a few. And the guys already have guns at Farshtayr. And he get. There's a whole discussion if there's such a thing, persumen is. So someone said, Vikum tips, menoitis outside. So someone said, one guy says, what do you mean? It says, Allah, persumen is. So everybody, persumen is? You ever heard such a thing? Persumen is means. So someone writes over there. I like the way he writes. He says, the Alter Rebbe didn't do it. The Divrei Chaim, these are the ones I remember. The Divrei Chaim didn't do it. And he mentions like another six. And then the Lubavitch of Patent was on it. This is, hey, whatever. He writes very not nice. All right. Now, okay. The guys are klotz, and the guys are goylem. And a chapzach garnished as follows. Think about the millions of Jews. By the way, the Gemara says, let's just stop for a second. Rashi brings it. Parsha's a boy. It says that when it came the time for the Geula to happen, for Mashiach to come, for in the time of Mitzrayim, Amareb, who is the one who says it? Amareb. Ramasya bin Choresh. As a Giyaz man, Ace Doidim, he Giyah, it came the time of love, it came the time, the Abish, Giyah, Ace, I should take the Yidna Mitzrayim. And the Abish says, I can't be goyel them, why? But Adem, the area, you're naked, there's no mitzvahs, I can't take them out without any mitzvahs. So therefore, I'm giving you Dam Pesach and Dam Mila, so Yidden should be able to have something to come to the Geula. So you come into Lubavitch Rebbe and sent out an army of Shulchim across the world. And they mamish reach all the Yidden. It's hard to find a Yid who didn't put on tefillin yet. Every Yid, Pashat, great them from Mashiach. It's not stopped. There's an Indian of Avos Yisrael, for sure. But there's something much deeper. There's an Indian of the Yid of Sechreit and Siddiq Yula. So, but there are Yidden who, for whatever reason, are not going to put on tefillin. They're not going to do it. Or they haven't done it yet. But think about the millions of Jews, who are walking through malls on Hanukkah. And all over they're seeing, you know, the guy with the red and the big beard. And the big flower, the tree with all the things. Eleptzich mamish in ganzen nitzmas beina umois. Aneshama kedoshah, achelek lekai mimal mamish, just like mine and yours, doesn't make a difference that I wear a shtraimel and he's married chas v'sholem to a shiksa, doesn't make a difference. Because mi idea besoid haneshamas, no one knows who's a higher neshama. Amulas, their highest neshamas, are in a very, very low place. I didn't make that up, as I state in the Arizal. That after the highest souls sometimes come down in the darkest places. Go in Lubavitch today and you'll find chassidim that are so malavigodish. They're so powerful. They're so great. And if you would look at them 20 years earlier, see what kind of hippies they were or what kind of lifestyle they led, you wouldn't believe it. And, okay. Drein sich azelchi yidin. And they see a menorah. And as he sees the menorah, he's not going to go over. The latke or the sufganiyah over there, the donuts is tempting, but because he's so frightened of this, intimidated by this Jewish experience, he's very scared. He doesn't know what to do with it, so he'll stay at a distance. He'll look from far. His family is busy. In the corner of his eye, he's looking, and his eyes tear up. For a moment, he tears up because he remembers he's a yid, and there's something about those lechtelich that are pulling at his neshama. And at this moment, what does the Gemara say? The Gemara says that when a person is Mekadish and Isha, Afilu hu Rasha Gomor, but he says, I'm a Nashani Tzadik Gomor, not Stamet Tzadik, Tzadik Gomor, it's a Sufik Mekudeshes, Shema Hirer Tshuva Beliboy. If you look in Tanya and you see what kind of Simcha the Eivishta has, when an Ishama that is Beshivya, that is stuck b'imkei haklipas, makes its return lihishtapech al chekovia. She pours herself out. This neshama, for one moment, this neshama yearned to reconnect to the Eibishter. This is a moment of tshuva. A neshama came home. Does anybody have an understanding? And we will never know who these millions of silent Baal Tshuvas are, from these Menoides that are all over the world that the Lubavitch Rebbe instituted, that this guy in Vafsiz Nayas decided this is Avodah Zarah, this is because he's stiff and he's constipated and he never opened up his Yiddishkeit a little bit to appreciate that stiffen in his Yiddishkeit. Arachmanis. But I wanted to ask him the question, this fellow. I wanted to ask him the question, the same person. When we Lubavitch has talked that the Lubavitch Rebbe is Mashiach, he says, so he say, and people say like this, the Lubavitcher Rebbe could have been Mashiach. See, everything, everybody comes on board, like 10 years later, everybody's masking to every. When the Rebbe started doing Baal Tshuvas, it took 20 years till everybody started doing Baal Tshuvas. The Rebbe started doing this mitzvah, and then everybody follows the Rebbe, because the Rebbe is the leader of the Bnei Yisrael, no shadow of a doubt. When it comes, people say, I'm Mashiach, the Rebbe could have been Mashiach. That was before Gimel Tammuz. Now that after Gimel Tammuz, Stalkos, this and that, the Rebbe can't be Mashiach anymore. And if you say, no, maybe he can come back because you bring the Gemara, Imen Chaya, Imen Mesa. He says, oi, Baz, oi, Imen Mesa, and was nicht der alte Rebbe. Aber versteh dich nicht. Chodem mit Terze, one thing is answered with the other. No, what are you asking? It should have been the alte Rebbe. Well, Debbie, you just told me that the alte Rebbe did not put up Menoides on the streets, and the alte Rebbe didn't, and the Lubavitch Rebbe. Yeah, why didn't the alte Rebbe put up Menoides? The alte Rebbe didn't have the same, what? He didn't figure out what the Lubavitch had ever figured out. First of all, didn't need it those days. It wasn't that same. But Demons wasn't the time yet. Demons of the Gedaf, that Durichbrechen, that Sechel and Nushi, should be able to hear a Lukus. So the Alter Rebbe was Mashiach and is Mashiach and brought a Lukus down into the Moyach Adam. But the Rebbe, his job is to bring the Geula down, Ba'olam Azeh HaGashmi, physical world, Mamish. So that it's not enough that you're learning Chassidus Ayid Zitzt and Davent mit Samach Vav. It has to be that on a mall, Mamish in a mall, I don't know what the mall over here in London is, that in the middle of the mall, in the middle of Rishus Arabim, Shem Rishus Arabim, is the Yidin that dance, and Yidin light a menoida, and Yidin see the Eibishter, and they see a Lokus, in the middle from the Grabim world. That's what it is. That's what it is. So the Rebbe starts mamish being Mishana Olam. Step after step after step after step. He's moving and bringing stronger and stronger. And then we know, well, let me think about it just for a moment. We think about both Alpi Pnimius HaTayra and Alpi Nigla HaTayra. What's the job of Mashiach? What's he supposed to do? We spoke earlier that the Iker Indian of Mashiach is that he has to be Megala Tayra Chadosh HaMe'iti Teitzah. He has to be Megala Pnimius HaTayra. Where is Megala Pnimius HaTorah in our generation? Ooh. If anybody learns, I remember the first time I came to Kfar Chabad, I was learning in Bnei Brak then in Slobodka Yeshiva. I ended up megachapting, oh my God, Solobavich, let's go for Yud Beis Tammuz. So I went, there was a Shabbos, Shabbaton for Bochrim. So I went for Shabbos. When I came there for Shabbos, it was like a Shmak of Shabbos, Freilich was beautiful. And there was a yid, there was mashpia of Zalman Gopin, and he gave a shir. It was a shir in the Rebbe's Maimer. It's the first time I never learned Chassidus before. I was always a searcher. I used to learn all the svarim that people didn't learn. I learned a lot of Maral. I used to learn, I learned Sichas Musaf and Abchaim Shmulevitz, and I learned, Rebbe Vizahister, Michtav Melio. And then I learned all Chassidus Svarim as well. I used to learn a lot. They used to call me Yeshiva that I would learn the Mass Mitzvah Svarim, because no one was learning those Svarim. I used to learn Gemara. I was always learning the more Spala Machshava Digi Svarim. Fine, but Tanya, I didn't know about it. It was outside of my frame of reference. So, but then when I went there for Shabbos, and then Sunday, and then the Shabbos morning, Hatagalenit Amaim, and the Maimon was Yud Beis Tammuz, Hasan Nafshenu Bachayim. So he teaches the Maimon Hasan Nafshenu. So first of all, it's very Gishmak. Because the Maimer begins Issa Benoyim Alimelech. Veikach Koirach. Issa Benoyim Alimelech. Now that was very refreshing, because one of the things that people get bothered very much is they realize there's certain things that is that Lubavitch has have this Gestaltskeit as only ours is. And I don't like that. No one likes that. And that's silly, because it's not only. It's just that there is a Kavanah, there's Pnimius, Pnimius Shebe Pnimius, Pnimius Shebe Pnimius. So when I hear the Rebbe the Melech and the Rebbe is building, it's amazing, because how many Mamadim are there in Lubavitch where the Rebbe begins a Maimer based on an Oymer the Melech? Come out now, I guess it was my time. So that, for me at least, that Maimer was there. In any case, by the way, I heard, I didn't hear this directly, but I heard this, I mean, I heard it on a tape. I didn't hear it from the Rebbe's mouth. The Rebbe says like this. I remember it, the early days I heard it. The Rebbe says like this. And the Rebbe tonight on the video, I heard something similar. The Rebbe said like this. Der was is heint von anash, oder der was is morgen von anash, oder der was is übermorgen von anash. Weil soif kol soif willen alle Jiden sein von anash. Weil der alte Rebbe hat gesagt, dass Chassidus ist Lakoil, und der Rebbe der Schwer hat gesagt, dass Heint ist gekommen der Zeit auf dem. So the Rebbe is not ashamed, he's not embarrassed to say that you should know that everybody's going to be Lubavitch Chassidim. What does that mean? Is he arrogant? He's looking for more Chassidim. If the Rebbe was looking for a lot more Chassidim, the Rebbe said once, if I would put on a Shtreimel, I would have like another amount, a lot of you know, the Rebbe is not looking for Chassidim because he needs Chassidim. The Rebbe is saying like this, Pasha to Indian. The Rebbe is saying, what do you mean Lubavitch Chassid? Lubavitch Chassid means someone who learns Chassidus. That means that a Lukus fills his mind. At a Leden to Lukus, at a Lepmet to Lukus. I'm talking about not someone who's a Chabad carrying member. If you're a Chabad carrying member, okay, fine, you know, that's also nice. It's always like Zika connection. But it has nothing to do with that. It has to do with Pasha learns Chassidus. So Lubavitch Chassid is Makushim et Nerev, a land Chassidus. And what's going to be when Mashiach comes? What's Mashiach? We're just saying the Nigin. Umola Ha'aretz Deyas Hashem. So Umola Ha'aretz Deyas Hashem is Chassidus Chabad. That's Deyas Hashem. It's knowing the Yebishter and Oifen of Seichel. So the Rebbe says everybody will be a Chassid. So I'm learning that Maimer over there. And while I'm learning it, I remember Benny Gansen said Reit Kavari, because I couldn't believe that this, the person who said this Maimer, I asked the person sitting, to Sven Hantigenem. If this was said by someone 300 years ago, one thing. But I'm hearing such giluyim and such light from, and I can't believe that a tzaddik who is alive today can say such. And I remember I wanted to like just scream like a madman out of excitement that I can't believe that all this light is here in Chav Garnish Das Gewist. In any case, so I met, when I came in the beginning to Lubavitch, I met one of the early people I learned Chassidus was with Mendel Vechter. He gave shiurim in Bnei Barak. Somehow I got to his shiurim. So I once asked him, Vibestik Akimen, what was your story? So Mendel Vechter told me an interesting thing. He said that he was learning Chivena Afaya, the Gesatmer Chassid. But he was a Baal Machshava. He was a person. So he learned Chassidus, and he also learned Chassidus Chabad. And he even gave shiurim in Satme Bismedrish in Lakita Torah. Okay. One day he realizes as a fashtaitis nisht, a redivert, a malak alam and saiba kalam and here and here, but he's not really understanding. And he heard that in Lubavitch there's a yid, his name is Rabbi Yoel Kahn. When Rabbi Yoel Kahn, when er geta shir, herstish, rint, pshi, azar shir. So therefore he said he wants to know what Rabbi Yoel Kahn. But he couldn't go. If he has for shalom, would go to Rabbi Yoel Kahn shir and satma, they find out, you see, taka, what happened to him later, that it's not going to be good. So he was very, very scared. So he somehow managed to ask and figure out a way that he can learn with Rabbi Yoel Kahn b'chavrusa. And looks like whoever was arranging said, this guy can be a big fish. So Rabbi Yoel learned with him. The first time they learned Chassidus, Rabbi Yoel didn't learn. Oh, but he made a Tanai. This is what he made a Tanai. He made a Tanai with Rabbi Yoel Kahn. He said, ich lehn no Chassidus, ich will lehn a bis de friedige Rebbe. The Rebbe of Shabbos is not given kushen, but find the Friedige Rebbe, and then fangs chunzioines with masses, ich kenish no more, klenish noch the Friedige Rebbe. Okay, deal is a deal, Rabbi Yoel is maskim. They started the first night, they learned Mamala Kalam and Sevil Kalam, the whole night. He says they started, he took 4 or 5 hours. When he left, he was dizzy because he was trying, he remembered like this. There the Chanapikoides, and Chanapikoides, and Chatzioini and Apikoides. Nor was then, and he, so when he went home, he said he was trying to reconcile in his brain. He never heard it so sweet. And he had to keep on reminding him, but he's an apikaitis, so let's just keep the two separated. He went to him a second time, and they started learning Shara Yichud Ve'emuna. And for week after week, the biyurim were unbelievable. Basmakavit is actually one of the words I heard in Lubavitch. I never heard it outside. So it's a Russian word. I don't know what the... In any case, what happened? One day he comes to the end of Perek Dalid at the beginning of Perek Hei in Shara Yichud Ve'emuna. He comes to the end over there and darkness do our beer from the Lubavitcher Rebbe. And if you don't learn that beer, it's very, very hard to make heads and tails of what the Alter Rebbe wants. But Rabbi Yoel had made up a deal with him that he's not going to teach him. He's not going to teach him the chassidus from the Rebbe. So he went up gedavent. So Remendel said, the chassidus ibrul gestamer azecha his beirim. You give me such explanations, and here you explain. So he says, because over here there's a beer of an alter chassid. That's what he said to him. And you said you want to only learn pure, whatever. So I'm not. He said, no, can't learn it. Alter chassid can't learn it. So he starts explaining to him the end of Perek Dalet and the beginning of Perek Hey. I'll pee the Rebbe's, it's the Rebbe's beer, fine. He said, once or twice, I don't remember exactly. I felt it and I knew it, but it was so sweet, it was so unbelievable, and that was it. He said to me then, Mendel said, he says, I had so many questions against Lubavitch, and I never got to ask even one question. Why? Because once you start learning Chassidus, and you start looking at the world from a much deeper place, from a much more pneumistic place, then you don't have kashas. You see that your whole perception is so, it's very limited. That's the point. It's very shallow. Compared to someone, you learn Tifkeit, you learn the oimik of what it means to be a yid, and what is an ishama. Suddenly, everything that Lubavitch did and does, and the Rebbe told you, makes so much sense. It's so on the mark. In any case, so what is the Rebbe? The Rebbe teaches pnimius atoira, oimik, pnimius atoira, unbelievable. The very same Lubavitch Rebbe is the one who takes achrayas for the Jewish people, like no other tzaddik, and everybody knows that. Everybody knows that. All the Rebbe Lakewood, Zartzach for Lakewood, all the Rebbe's, he's zorgen sich that they should have Diras for his Chassidim and people, and that's his job. He has to take care of his Chassidim, and he has to be starken Yiddishkeit amongst them, and so on and so forth. One person who appears when, in the end on Friday, going back to the time, right before it's already getting close to Chatzos on Friday, and suddenly puts the pedal to the metal, which means he puts his foot down on the gas, and he pushes it down all the way, and he accelerates 120 miles per hour. He's pushing the Yidden to the Geula like no other person ever did before. And his Ashpa is Chayvik Oilemois. Pnimius HaTorah, touching every single Jew, and when you look in Rambam, and you see Yamoid Melech, a Melech will get up. Yamoid Melech, the Yaakov Kol Yisrael. So first of all, I just want to say one word on Yamoid Melech. One of the things that took me so deeply when I came to Lubavitch, and as I mentioned to you, I grew up in Baruch, where Stachin and Chassidim, Stachin is a klein Chassidim, Chassidim Chassach Derayin by the Kloizim of Rebbe. I have a lot of personal stories with him. It's unbelievable. A tzaddik, unbelievable. The way he watched the Kloizim of Rebbe Davin, it was like, it was on some, and I was around the block, let's say it that way. I went. There was one thing that Meganim, the first time I came to the Rebbe, it was by Kloishol Bracha. Sitz Tayid, he doesn't have the blue Bekeshe that I'm used to. He doesn't have the Shtraimel. He doesn't have the whole thing. Well, it's mad, like the Rebbe's hat. But here's the thing. It might sound silly, but it was something that I picked up on the first second. What did I pick up? It's in Toizn Techsidim, it was Koshel Bracha. In the Zink, whatever thing they were singing, Allah Salah Hach, or whatever it was. And suddenly the Rebbe picks up his hand and get on Macha Zay. And suddenly you can feel the electric pulse just shoot through your body. You can feel it in your toes. There is such an electricity in that room that I've never seen. It's as if the Rebbe has his hands in everybody's kishke. And the Rebbe macht a zoi, and suddenly it's a flame, like, and it's instant. And you saw, and you can sense and feel that there is a certain hiskashrus and bonding between these people and their Rebbe, that tzaddik that's over here, that I've never seen anywhere else. And what you really notice, if you recognize, is you see Malchus. Malchus means that there is a Melech. He's an Ish Merumam. He's very exalted. The people sense that he is way, way, way above them. But they also sense that he's completely, 100% even committed to their well-being, and they bond with him, and they submit to him in a way that they're willing to do whatever he wants. Unbelievable. I've never seen that before. I remember I have a chaver. His name is Spitzer. He's a shaychet in. He came from Panovich. He was with me Shabbos in Kfar Chabad. He was one of the bachrim. I came from Slobodka. Came from Panovich. And he, remember when he came back Tishrei from the Rebbe, and I asked him, so how was it? Remember standing in a street corner of Bnei Brak talking about the Lubavitch Rebbe? So he tells me, the Vaisti says, Azuch Mitzrayzuch Mitzayazam, Vusa Tana Tos, because what did a Tana look like? I try to pick a picture. And look at the Chazanish. He has a, I'm trying to think, what did he look like? But he says, if I'm trying to imagine what David the Melech Yisrael looked like, what kind, the Rebbe by Hakafis? And it's not. I mean, I was by the Shleim of Babiv too. It's a different kind of a connection. It was nice. It was regal. It was malchustik. But it's not. It's not on this level of depth. The Babiv could not get his chassidim to go across the entire world and be mois and nefesh for their entire life. They couldn't do it. It would never work. It would never work. It wouldn't even be something even. The Rebbe shikta los chassidim, and they're willing to do anything. They're batel and mevutel. There is such a yiskashru, such a bitul from every type. That's malchus. And then the Yaakov Kol Yisrael, the Rebbe starts the campaigns to touch every single Jew. Miyamois hois Yisrael a goy. There was never such a movement of our batzis ha-toyrim by Yidin like the Rebbe did. It's a nishkevein, our batzis ha-mitzvahs. It didn't exist, and everybody knows that. So when you look both mitzad pnimiyus ha-toyrim and mitzad, what the Rambam says, it becomes so clear. But then, this is all what? Leading up to Tav Shin Nun. Tav Shin Nun is Friday, midday. Based on the cosmic clock that we spoke about before. So it comes Friday, midday, if you take 250 days from 250 years from when the Baal Shem Tov came, you get to Tav Shin Nun, and in Tav Shin Nun, there's Mitten Tog, then once you start serious preparation for Kabbalah Shabbos, the Rebbe says, Igi Azman Gulaschem. And the Rebbe starts pointing that the Zinyanim in the world that happened, that are unbelievable, that never happened before. And I want to conclude, but I just want to share one thing. The Rebbe says at Tav Shin Nun, what did the Rebbe tell us? He said, for instance, he says that the Russian communist regime collapsed. La'oirich kol goloseinu. According to the length of our entire golos, Yidden were always under what's called Shibud Malchiyos. And what does Shibud Malchiyos mean? That there is some nation that we are subservient to, that doesn't allow us in Torah and Mitzvahs. The greatest esnagdus to observance of Torah and Mitzvahs since the days of Antiochus was Stalin and the Russian. And the tzaddist and the ruthlessness. And I don't even know if the Yavanim were as cruel as they were. It was just horrible in Rusland. And Chassidim was Amgalit and Rusland believed in their minds. They even had a munah that Mashiach is going to come, but they couldn't believe that this ruthless monster is ever going to be broken. And what happened? A nesh she'en kamoyu. And the Rebbe, by the way, is the only one who predicted the nesh before that. The Rebbe said, it's with the Gans and Samfal. And what happened? Russia collapsed. The Soviet Union collapsed. Without one bullet fired. Revolutions in the world usually cost such a revolution. A ganze Medina Mapecha. Overnight, boom, the ganze Welt was standing mishtoimim. How can this be? Hegias Mangolatsa. You know what it means that there isn't a place in the world today that a Yid can't, that doesn't allow a Yid to learn to do a mitzvah? I'm not suggesting that you should walk into Riyadh in Saudi Arabia with your tefillin or outside. But there is no official government that forbids Yiddishkeit. It never happened. So the Rebbe said already in Tav Shin Nun, Yidden chever daf verstehen, the golus hat sich geendigt. The pnimius. Igiyaz mangul naschem. The golus is already falling apart. And the Rebbe continues and continues. And he's telling us from week to week, sterker and sterker and sterker and sterker, and lighting the fire amongst the chassidim. Unbelievable. Here's Mangalas. Nachtim, what happened? We have a Helen Bahaster. We have a time of concealment. We have a time of darkness. And therefore what? So a lot of people say this makes so much sense. Aber es ist gesagt, Aber das hat sich drei Tage zusammen schicken, Geister, drei Tage nicht mehr kommen. Er wird aufsteigen. Er wird aufsteigen. Ihr glaubt nicht, der Lubavitcher Rebbe. Die glaubt, aber der Lubavitcher Rebbe geht aufsteigen. Er geht herankommen und sagen, die ganze Arme schicken, sie hat keine mit der ganzen Arme, die ganze Arme schicken. That's, and the Tainer is a good Tainer. It's a good Tainer. I don't have an excuse why it happened, but is it consistent with Yiddishkeit? Is it consistent with what we know? 100%. By Moshe Rabbeinu, the Goyal Rishon came, and then he was Nigla, the Choyzer, the Nigla, the Niskasa, the Choyzer, the Nigla. Look inside Rabbeinu Bechai in the end of Sefer Shemois, and when he went and afterward he was Niskasa, it became very dark and difficult to the point that Moshe Rabbeinu calls out to the Eibishter, Lama Ra'oysa La'amazeh. And in Kisvei Arizal, in different places, it talks about this concealment. They all talk about it. Question is, how long? 3 months, this, that. I remember after Gimel Tammuz, we were all waiting. Skendich Nijan, another month, this and that. So, ain't itonu yoidea ademah that there is such a concealment. But we do know that everything in Yiddishkeit comes through avoida. And everything in Yiddishkeit comes with blood and tears. Things are not easy. Especially the Mekinta Durchbrechen, the biggest thing in all of history. The biggest thing, should we accept, should we believe that that's going to go smoothly without a Nisayan? Without a tremendous Nisayan? For everybody. Talking about the Jewish people. I'm talking a Nisayan for Lubavitch. For the biggest Mekusharim of the Lubavitch Rebbe. Those who believe that the Rebbe and every word is Shechinah Medaberes Metoich Groinai. Has the Toizen to Lubavitch Chassidim, who believe, Namish. You know, the Rav Ben Eberak, Ramatul Ashkenazi, Olav HaShalom, his, Ramatul Ashkenazi, his father, who is it again? Krachabad, I mean. Ramatul Ashkenazi, Rav of Krachabad, what's his father's name?
Ramosh.
Ramosh Ashkenazi, Zamul Gekimen, once came to Lubavitcher Rebbe on Yechidus, in the early years, and he wrote down, and he wrote, and the Rebbe spoke to him, when he left Yechidus, he forgot what the Rebbe spoke to him. And he had a lot of, it bothered him very much. He went off Yechidus, he forgot what the Rebbe said. He felt very uncomfortable, but he had no other choice because the only other person knows what was said is the Rebbe. So he asked the Rebbe if the Rebbe can maybe remind him, write him down or something, what was spoken at the Yechidus. So the Rebbe answered him, Be'ez ha-Yechidus, Shechino medaberes v'chul. The Rebbe said, "Beshas Yechidus, the Shechinah medaberes." And if it's Shechinah medaberes, I don't necessarily have to remember what happened. Beshas Ma'is, the Shechinah medaberes. The Rebbe doesn't gezogt, and Chassidim know this bepashtes. This is when the Rebbe speaks to someone privately in Yechidus. When the Rebbe sits fabrengen after fabrengen for over two years, and he talks, the Rebbe says. And the Vu is Siddiqui Kimin. Learn the Pasha Shoiftim Sicha. The Rebbe says that for thousands of years, the Rebbe says it doesn't say, but in days Malachi and Chagi is Bata, that says over there, what's the Lashon? The Nevuah. What's the Lashon? Nistalka Nevuah, the Lashon. So the Rebbe says it doesn't say Batla. It says Nistalka. It went away, but doesn't mean, and he brings from the Rambam that the Rambam says, that before Mashiach comes, that Chazoras. Hanavua who betnai or something like that before Mashiach comes is coming back Navu. So the Rebbe goes on to say, and if you strip away the words that Rebbe is using, you see the Rebbe saying in these words, I, Lubavitcher Rebbe, am the Navi of the generation, and I am coming to you to tell you what God spoke to me. You understand? And the Rebbe spielt like that. He's not saying those words, but that's what he's saying. Der Eibishter allein hat geredt mit mir, in hat mir geheißen. Zugen enk, as etzel zugen a jede yid, me farsen bechol le oilo me giyaz man gulaschem. Nuchtem is geworden tinkel, choyshe chafela. And people come confused. Even Lubavitch gets confused. It's a big nesayin. It's a big test. But we the Jewish people are made out of iron. Now where do you see the iron? Small little shilichel over here in London. Called the Beis Mashiach of a banda akshanim. Akshanim. You look at them on the street, you say, oh, they're the Lubavitcher Tzedraita. Okay, let me ask you. Has this not been the story with the Nevi'im? Don't you remember the story when the Navi said that tomorrow, we all read it in the Haftarah, when the Navi said that tomorrow it's going to be, what is it over there, Saab B'Shekel, that the food is going to be Emot Gelacht, and the person laughed, it's not going to happen. He said, it's going to happen, you're not going to see it, you're going to be there, but you're not, from there you're not going to eat. The Rebbe is going to make that everybody is Seichel. There's no Shaila. There's no going back on that. It's absolute. It's 100% MS. There's no Shaila. And what happened in the last 20 years? You take a look at the world and you're seeing in Yonim Nifloyim that are happening. The world is changing in a very, very massive way. The last 2 years, we see unbelievable things that are Mamish Melech HaMashiach doing it, or else it doesn't make any sense. This whole Trump business that came and took the entire world and Ibigikert, he flipped the whole world over, is an absolute act of Melech HaMashiach. That's why they keep on connecting him with Chabad. The New York Times just put an article out about the Jews in America are split over Trump, and they say the whole article is that, yeah, because Kushner is connected with Chabad, and so on and so forth. And everybody knows the video that right before he was elected as president, Kushner and his wife went to Daven by the Rebbe's oil. On Bechlau, you see, the day that he was appointed to become officially president of the United States was on Yutes Kislev. It wasn't the election, but it was the day when the Electoral College voted him in, was Yutes Kislev. When he announced Yerushalayim to be the capital of Yidna, by the way, it has nothing to do with Medinas Yisrael. Medinas Yisrael didn't even want him to announce Yerushalayim. They want to go to Zaman with the Arab. Netanyahu is dreaming for the day that he can be the ultimate peacemaker and give away Chas V'Shalom and poor parts of Eretz Yisrael. They didn't want it. There's nothing to do with him. This is Pashat Mashiach Sanarabit. He announces Yerushalayim. Imagine that. Till last year, the Yutes Kislev, it never was in the history of the world. The Goyim were never maskim that Yerushalayim, the Arab and the Muslim said it belongs to them. The Christian says it belongs to them. Everybody claimed it. Shtel Tzachov, the president of the biggest country in the world, the most powerful country in the world, notwithstanding that the whole world is tzeridit of him, they're scared of him, but they're all going crazy about him. And he makes that announcement. Do you know what that means, Benegay, the Sodom Lamaila? Do you know what it means that Lamaila, there is a, what we see down here is only a little reflection of the Sodom Lamaila that they had to conceive. And now Brazil is going to follow, and this one is going to follow. We're seeing in Yonim Nefloim, that happened, Yutes Kislev. And then a continuation to that, who does he release from prison? The Rubashkins, the first person. And you remember, and I remember just a year ago, how we felt like Mashiach was here for a day. Yidden felt that Mashiach is gekemen. There was such a hergish. Unbelievable. You see, Chofches Sivan is the day the Rebbe came to America. Chofches Sivan, the day the Rebbe came to America. Do yourself a favor. Take the Rebbe's Sicha, Tovshin Nun Aleph, Chofches Sivan, where the Rebbe is explaining what is the meaning of him. He doesn't talk about himself. He talks about Nasi Dareinu or whatever. But you see, what is the significance of him coming to America? The Rebbe says the significance is that this is the end of Matan Torah. Matan Torah comes to make shalom between the Eibishter and the world. When the Rebbe comes to America, he's bringing the ultimate chibur of Elyonim and Tachtonim. Fine. And it makes peace in the world. And from then comes peace to the nations. On that very day, Trump does the most craziest thing in the world. He has a meeting with Kim Jong-un. A guy who 2 months before, you remember, I'm not telling you, they were arguing who has a bigger nuclear button. And this guy's a maniac. This guy could have nuked the world. And suddenly, boom, machter shalom. And the Rebbe spoke about all these things. The Rebbe says that this is all the koyach of Mashiach Tzidkenu that's causing all of this. We can go on and on and on, but I'm talking too much. So I want to say one thing, L'chaim Eden. The Avoida now is like this. The Avoida now to all of us simply means, Chevre, there's no time. There is no time. It's happening. It's happening in front of our eyes. What we need to do, B'Pay Olmam, is Chabtz Chassidus. Learn, man. Because without Chassidus, then you can't see it. You just can't see it. The Olam Kim Hagenayeg, and you remain stuck in a Chitzoniyistig world, and you push it, not tuning into what's happening. You learn Chassidus. The more you learn, and then you start learning, learn the Rebbe's Sichas of Nun. Don't only learn that, because you understand. You have to learn Tanya, you have to learn. Learn! Make it serious. Commit to Chassidus. This is not a joke. I'm not saying this because of a party line. I couldn't care less. I don't belong to anybody. The Lubavitchers don't like me today either. I became already a troublemaker. Verstehst? It's not, I'm not interested. I never came. I never tried to make anybody happy. I never tried. I'm telling you the emes. This is the reine emes. This is the truth. Higiyas mangulaschem. The Rebbe cared the welt. Any second the Giyula is coming. And therefore, we can't be caught by surprise. It's not going to be comfortable. So therefore, we can all take a chelik in that. The more chassidus we learn, we spread it to other Yidden. And we'll see any moment. It's happening mamish without a shadow of a doubt. Any moment it's going to happen. So we all say together, Yechi adeneinu, meireinu, verabeinu, melech ha-moshiach, li'oilom, vod, l'chayim, u'l'brachim.
All right.